iCam, brought to you by Toyota.
Nathan, Barry's going to be doing the toss today. Barry, when you're ready, Nathan, your call, mate. Heads it is.
So Anthony Kurtifidis wins the toss. We'll kick to the left of screen. Nathan Thompson, the acting captain of Hawthorn tonight. And the beautiful pictures there coming from the Toyota Skycam. Enjoying it on Friday Night Football and enjoying the call of the man who is without doubt the number one caller in the country. Dennis Committee, welcome aboard, Den.
Thanks, Ed. Tough one to pick, isn't it? Carlton haven't won two games in a row since 2001, so most tipsters going for them tonight.
It's going to be a big game. Let's go down to Tony Jones, boundary side. Good evening, Tony.
Yes, good evening, Eddie. Good evening, everyone. Well, a little reward up for grabs for the best of field tonight. This is, of course, the David Parkin medal. It was struck last year for the first time. Shane Crawford was the winner, you might remember, at the MCG. He won't be out there tonight, of course. Just a little bit of drama, Ed, for the Commission Chairman in Ron Evans. It was revealed at the Carlton dinner tonight, where he's a guest, that his beloved Mercedes has been knocked off today. Ian Collins told the gathering that it went in for a service and was last seen, this is according to Collo, at about 4:30 with an oriental-looking gentleman behind the wheel. So the APB is out for Ron Evans Merck.
It's a beautiful 500 SL convertible too, so poor old Ron won't be too happy at all. Nor will Andrea, because she'll be very disappointed, Andrea Evans. Let's go down to Hollywood. Doc Larkins, who's back from America. Welcome back, Pete.
Yeah, good day. Thanks, Ed. Well, no surprise, Anthony Kurtifidis starting on the bench tonight. A bit more conservative than his round seven game against the Pies when he played the whole game, so expect him to come on and run around a little bit. Jared Wade coming back. And, of course, Sam Mitchell out for about 3 weeks for Hawthorn. So I'll be looking forward to the game tonight.
We're looking forward to it, and away we go, because it's on already.
Opening bounds, Everett knocks it down. Hodge emerges with the football. We've got a whistle. It's coming back. It's a free kick to Stevens.
Well, Tallis has got Stevens, and they're niggling on early in the piece. Umpires will be aware that this is a big game, and they'll pick a couple out early.
Stevens, probing kick, well inside the 50. In from the side, Prendergast, off hands, loose ball at the back. Dixon knocks it towards the boundary line, keeps it in, hand passes indiscriminately. Osborne was in there. So to Bateman, wants the boundary line, out it goes.
Oh.
It'll be tossed in.
It's hot already, boys.
Well, if Carlton had a sense of humour, that'd start a blue.
It always going to be hot, wasn't it? This first 10 minutes will be very interesting viewing.
Camporelli pushed to the ground. Clark holding on to him. Throw in. Big Lance got the tap on the ball. They're in there hard. Oh, Camporelli high on Everett. Play on. The kick out of the pack there came from Johnson, the former Hawk, up towards full forward. There's Crowe. Look at him go. He looks like a rampaging bull as he boots the kick out towards the wing position. Up high, Barker caught one high. We'll get the free kick against Morrell.
Spider Everett. Pushing forward, trying to get through play.
Brennan's kick up towards half forward, looking for Everett. He didn't get the bounce. Good play at the fall of the ball there by Williams. Hard at it. Wouldn't give it up. Scotland now breaks the tackle, slams it on the boot, tries to get close to the boundary line. It comes out to Barker. Now it's Green. Twisting and turning. Went without it under pressure from Camporelli. Throw it in. Whoa, what a start. The best minute and a half to a game we've seen for a long time on Friday Night Football. This has got everything. It's ready to go. The tinderbox is ready to light. Dennis, away we go.
Boundary throw in front of our commentary position then. Whitnell, very conscious of Everett, who fell from a great height and slow to get up. Got a bounce. Whitnell backed into Everett, who crashed to the turf. Watch this again.
Got to watch the ball.
Oh, that would hurt.
Penetrometer reading was officially dead tonight on the Telstra Dome surface. Dennis, a little bit softer.
Dixon went down. Norman overran it. Waite in trouble. Too slick for Stevens. Taken away by Dixon. Dragged down by Prendergast. Held too long. I think Dixon will get a free kick. It's coming back.
Had a good game last week, Ben Dixon at halfback after missing a bit of footy. Started well tonight.
So Dixon, he's already had a couple of touches already. That one wasn't a good one. Well read. As we said, the ground is a bit soft. Tallis went without it. Stevens, two good plays there. And we'll have a throw in.
A bit happening off the footy too. It's involving Corey McGrath.
And Osborne.
And Osborne.
So throw in. Smith tries to wrest the ball out of the way. Does it well. Ball spills there to Hodge. He just kicks it inside 50. Hopes for the best. Teague with the handball away. McGrath dives in on top of it. Teague holds it up. Umpire bounces. We're going to bounce 45 metres out. from the Hawthorn goal. Their first inside 50. No score on the board. We've been going 3.25 minutes.
Camporelli has got Tim Clark as his opponent for most of the night. Rees is running with Scotland and already said Tallis with Stevens.
There's the bounce. Everett tries to flick it down. Johnson with the outside of the boot. Gains about 25 metres. Held and a free kick, I think, to Waite as he approached the football.
Yeah, Trent grabbed the jumper before he actually accepted the ball. Just anticipated the possession.
Men on to the outer side. Will it get there in time? I doubt it. Brennan did well, knocked it on the deck. Barker's got it now. Slips a tackle. Camporelli arrives, took him down too high. Advantage is paid. Reece got it to Clark. The short one towards half court is marked by Thompson. Thompson wheels around, thought about going to the middle. Now goes for distance. Well, pulls the kick at the last moment. Teague came back, filled the hole. Wonderful carriage.
Put him in your top 5% of courageous players in the competition, David Teague.
Teague's kick stays in the air a long time, up towards Waite. Good play by Thompson, good pressure. Umpire called play on, said he did it legally. Now the ball for the Hawks, spills to the half-forward flank position. Coming out is Houlihan, under pressure, gets the handball inside to Waite, who didn't wait. Didn't take the ball, the pressure was on. It was a good turnover for the Hawks.
And they'll be taking note of that, Ed.
Yep,
they would take note of it. He's missed a fair bit of footy as Jared Waite. He just took his eyes off it. There's the free kick.
A good play by Hodge.
Already have 14 men for Carlton. Just pressing back from this kick.
Driving kick from Hodge up to Everett, who came out, met the ball, off hands. The ball spills to Brennan, is it? His kick is just off Lekas. In fact, it is. Lekas's kick offline, through for a point. So first score on the board to the Hawks. And we've got a very lively opening. Teague, look at this. That is absolutely fantastic.
He's been doing that all year, though. And he's done it in his career. He's just had a great opportunity at Carlton this season.
Well, interesting there from Williams as well. There's no report in that, but they've been red hot this week, the tribunal and those things.
You must be careful with the head, is the message.
Wiggins to DeLuca, chips to half forward. Whitnell runs to the 50. But his man in the air, that was young Brennan, runs on 30 metres out, veteran's goal.
Smart play by Lance Whitnell there. I don't know if he would have actually seen that it was a first gamer coming at him, and he would have been keen and eager to rush at him while he had the ball, but just the knowledge and awareness to hang on to the ball, seeing that the man approaching now, he's already seen Spider Everett. He knows he's not going to run him down from behind. He sees the overcommitment by the first gamer, Luke Brennan. Sidestep, and for, even if you're slow by foot, you can still give a good sleight of hand like that.
So Lance Whitnell opens game 150 in the best possible way. And doesn't he love it? Big Lance puts the Blues 5 points in front. Good bounce from the umpire. Up goes Everett. Got the tap. Smith out of the centre. Good smother, though, by the Blues. It was DeLuca who got his hand on the ball. It's Scotland now streaming forward. Tapavola. All right, Gary, what's his percentage outside 50 again?
It is outstanding, Edward. It is up around
83%. Right, 83% shot at goals from outside 50.
Great smother. Great smother in the middle of the ground, too, to affect this turnaround after Joel Smith gathered first.
39 goals, 18. Last week he kicked 7 goals. As we said, averaging better than 80% from outside the 50-metre arc.
Actually gave him a couple extra percent. He's about 80 on the money.
The boy from Beaconsfield, third in the best and fairest last year, the Blues leading goal kicker in 2003, lining up for goal. Is he on or is he off tonight? The big Fev comes in.
Good hit.
Oh. Put down your glasses. That's 10 rows back. Second in a row to the Blues.
Well, that is just Brendan Favola's cup of tea, and they could not have wanted a better start in terms of getting the ball into the hands of their two well, key forwards. Lance Whitnell's been down all year. Brendan Favola up and down. He was up last week, and that's the challenge for Jonathan Hay, is that you just, the first game back, he is deadly from almost any range.
Friday night football, Blues lead it by 11 points. Johnson, three possessions already. That's him running inside the centre square. Last appearance on Friday Night Football, 19 in the first half against Essendon, back in round four. There he is again. He's a master at finding the football. Kicks inside the 50, fell behind. Whitnell's got it, tries to lay it off. Over the shoulder, Norman kept it going. Lappin snaps, it bounces in the square, runs on it to goal. Oh, Jono.
He started like a bomb again, and Lance involved again. He started his 150th beautifully, and, well, Dennis Pagan's loaded up that forward line. He's got Matthew Lappin playing alongside Brendan Favola. Four clearances to Johnson already in this game.
Joel Smith is Brett Johnson's opponent, and Joel, he doesn't play in the middle all that much, but he's just trying to sniff the ball out himself rather than start shoulder to shoulder with Brett Johnson. But well done by Lance Whitnell. He kept the ball alive once more. And Lappin is the recipient on the outside.
Chance Bateman just lost him. He went to the contest with him and then started going after the footy. Lappin was just able to duck off around the back.
Well, the Hawks opened at fever pitch, but in the last three, four rows forward, they haven't got near the ball. Spider just tried to lay it off there to Hodge. And the Blues hard in underneath it. We'll start again. Three goals on the trot. Three in 3 minutes.
This is the great challenge now for the Hawks, is that they've had a big build-up and they have gone hard at it. A little bit happening here between Hodge and Prendergast.
Yeah.
But when you're three goals down after a few minutes, that's when you test your resilience.
Prendergast went in. Hodge takes it to the ground.
Notice that one there. Now, they have not got to recognise Ruckman here, Carlton. That last bounce down, three men went into body Peter Everett. See if they go him again. They're trying to swarm him so he doesn't get the hit.
Yep.
Three.
There it is.
Three again.
Teague was the third man up. He got the tap in the end. Whitnell used his body. The push off from Hodge. He'll get the free kick. Advantage has now been paid. It comes out the centre wing. The mark has been taken by Green. Green kicks forward. Up towards the forward 50 position. Offhand's Barker. Thornton from behind to DeLuca. Close on the boundary line. Gets the kick away. Waite has to go here. And it was a good mark taken by Croad under pressure.
Now, Carlton have already got the numbers back. They must use it wisely.
Hodge into Mines. Bateman arches the back. Kicks inside the 50. Will it carry? Two Hawks collide down there. Spills for Camporelli. Lays it off. Bowyer out of defence. It's coming back, though. Osborne forward at the wing to Croad. Loads up again. Indiscriminate kick. They come from all angles. Plenty of Blues there. Thompson cast in the role of a rover. Gets it away to Smith. Lines up. Snaps. Hasn't got the carry. You bet.
Now, one thing you'll know about Brett Johnson, he'll find the ball around the centre of the ground and he will give you clearances. He's a good... He does smell the ball out pretty well. But one thing he won't be able to do... If the ball moves into the forward line quickly, that's his opponent about to receive it now, Joel Smith. He doesn't have the power acceleration to run forward with him or cover him if Joel Smith runs forward. That's a good duel.
The disappointed Dennis Pagan would be with four defenders there that all flew together. They outnumbered Hawthorn 4-1 and just gave the footy up.
It was interesting, Crowe just bombed it in, but Gary, we say it week after week, sometimes you can over-finesse,
yep,
and sometimes the ball will just fall nicely if it's booted up there. Here we go again as Bowyer, this time a bit better with the direction of his kick, out to Lappin, takes it with one hand, then turns inside to Vivola. Did well to keep it in front of him, now he fights again. Picked up nicely there by Rees in his 50th game, gets it back, handballs off, Jacobs chips to centre-half back, Crowe. Goes out wide. That's a beautiful kick. Chance now for the Hawks as Hodge looks up, needs a target. Thompson provides. The kick was a shocker though, but it might come off. Campbell was lurking. Now it comes out to Barker. Williams is in there as well, looking for the kick. Barker can't pick it up. Now he's dragged to the ground. It spills to Hodge. Take two. Hodge flicks it out the back. Blues will get away with it now. Johnson goes at it. Whoa, in comes Smith. Out to Green. Kicks to the hot spot again. Teague gets pushed off the line. Good play by the Blues by Prendergast. And they live to fight another day as Bowyer says take two.
They're open down the middle of the ground. If they win it here, they're on, Carlton. If they can look inside now.
Scotland's got the football. Right half back. Norman's the man, I would have thought.
Bloodrule.
Teague.
Bloodrule. So,
Probably comes at a good time for the Hawks here. They were a little bit exposed up the middle, waited to snuck away. But the ruck situation is a very interesting one, Derm, that you highlighted. I mean, the players around Peter Everett Hawthorn, I'm talking about, need to be aware that Carlton are going to be second and third man up at every opportunity.
Well, and that double bounce down, Everett went twice. He contended with six opponents at two bounce downs. So they obviously recognise, with no recognised ruckman Carlton, Peter Everett is going to give his underneath players an armchair ride, so they have to do something about it.
Norman going to the back line now for Carlton, and Fisher to the forward line as Teague comes to have some treatment.
Well done by Wiggins, good hard running. Got it from Scotland. Ditto to Fisher just on the ground. So Fisher just forward of the wing. DeLuca is on for the long ball. Will he get to the contest? No. In from the side, Prendergast, knocked away by Hodge. Roving McGrath, high ball towards the pocket. Hay angles it towards the boundary line. Out it goes. You make it a free kick. No, will be tossed in.
Well done by Johnny Hay. Punched with his left arm then. He's obviously done a lot of work. And he normally just goes with the right fist. So it's amazing though, Gary. Some blokes can only punch one
it
arm.
Is.
But
it is.
I didn't know he was had that in his repertoire.
Spider, nice tap. Wiggins was at the fall of the ball. Desperate stuff at the moment in there, and the umpire will bounce. We're 25 metres out. Blues kicked three goals on the trot. Smith answered for Hawthorn. A margin 11 points. Everett again gets the tap. We'll say that all night. Camporelli squeezes the ball out as a chance for Smith. Off the halfback line, nothing up ahead, so I try to dribble it to the boundary line. Stevens picks up for the Blues. From outside 50, a driving kick. Lance is the only man back for Carlton. But he had the numbers against him. Jacobs just fended him off and allowed Hay to take the mark in the last line of defence.
And he'll get this.
Denny Jacobs. Nothing on, nothing on.
Oh! Now that is absolutely superb. And it's something that I'm not sure the big fella's done all that often. But gee whiz, he has set himself tonight.
Yeah, first game of Luke Brennan, just, well, that's an education for him. He's talking to Danny Jacobs and obviously not picking up the tempo quick enough and recognising him in seniors.
Well, Lance is starting from the pie stand here.
Well, Brennan Favolis sunk it from there last week.
He's very keen to kick this one, Lance. He comes in off two steps, a drop short, off hands. Oh, almost off there. Oh, Fisher couldn't quite get his boot to the ball. I hope my yell smothered what was said there by some of the players.
You're right near an effects mic down there, aren't you?
I think we have.
Well, he's Crady kicking in, and he's an exceptionally long kick. He'll look to go long, although there's not that many targets, so it's going to be test his accuracy short here unless Spider backpedals on the left-hand side of screen.
Whoever said it got it right. It was an ugly pack. There goes Crow towards the outer side. Spills to the side, picked up by Stevens. No one in particular. Well, Tallis finishes up with it. Floats one towards the wing. Boyer was up, held on to. Wiggins did very nicely. Got it to Norman alongside the centre circle. Kicks inside the 53. Hawks are there. And the mark is taken by Jacobs. Had his hands full last week of Matthew Lloyd. Out of defence to Reese. Right half back. Looks towards half forward. Needs to pinpoint the football. Barker couldn't hang on. Bounces off his chest and goes across the line. 9 minutes till quarter time. Carlton lead it by 12 points.
And Johnny Barker hasn't had a whole heap of it. Just handballs at the moment. One thing he is doing, which he hasn't been doing for most of the season tonight, he's actually leading up to the wings and making space behind him.
Oh, well, that's an interesting one. Whitnell gets the free kick against Lickus for a hold. This is almost as if the ruck was setting up 10 metres further up the ground. Nice kick from Lance Whitnell. The mark taken there by Wiggins. Wiggins was offloaded by Osborne. Wasn't that late, but it's going to be a free kick downfield. How about the bloke in the crowd? Let's stick with this.
I thought that was okay.
I thought it was all right too. I didn't think it was that late.
That's a free kick though. At ground level, the umpire thinks it's a bit late.
Okay, it's a free kick downfield, and Favola's got it 35 metres out directly
Peter
in front.
Everyone coming straight off, so Peter Schwab
thought it was a bit late. He will have a go, young Osborne. He's got some grunt in him. He's got to temper it and use it at the right time.
Yeah, a bit late. Yeah, and got him a bit high.
His right foot's still in the air when he actually gets him.
Yeah.
So he's only halfway through the action.
Vola kicks the fourth goal. His second for the night. The Blues get out to an 18-point lead.
Another one down.
And they're the ones you love from a full forward, the old down the ground. 4-1. Dennis Pagan going to be satisfied with that. Both sides attacking the footy. There hasn't been a problem with that. It's the score. But at the other end, at Hawthorn's end, Carlton are pushing numbers back at every opportunity. But I guess what's anticipated there from the bloke with the footy is that Osborne would go to the smother rather than go at the body. And that's why the free kick would have been paid.
18 points the margin then. Carlton looking far more accomplished in midfield and forward. Johnson again over the football. Tallis though charges in, taken down, ball up.
Well, the Carlton forward line is just open, wide open with space at the moment for Favola and Fisher and Whittle to work in. The other end of the ground, the Blues, well, they did have a spare back. It's good to see now Hawthorn have got numbers back, so it's one-on-one.
Bounce. Everett knocked it down. Teague's got it. Wrestled down. Kept it going. Loney slid in. Hodge held a long time. Wiggins over the football, going nowhere. And the bounce.
Now, if you pull away from this one, Peter Schwab on screen there, you see two Hawthorn players, Crowd on defensive side of pack by himself. Jacobs also. You only need one to be a sweeper. Crowd pushes up to the edge of the pack now.
Everett again, almost uncontested that time. Laid it down into the path of Lekas. Kicks inside the 50. Green with pace. Camparelli did very well. Got him on the angle. Close to the boundary line. Lads it. Knocks it. Goldwood on his knees. Attracted a crowd. Flicked it out to Green. Green goes back to Hodge, who wishes he hadn't.
Good result, though. You know, sometimes you've got to stand up and take a tackle when you know you can't get a ball out and just be content as Cooter starts to warm up. Have a listen for this roar. Been waiting since round 7.
He comes on, young Luke Brennan runs over to him. I think they'll probably swap Crowd onto him.
Hodge gets the handball out. Houlihan finding some space. Nice skills. Look at that with the left foot. Just turned it over.
Not that nice a skill.
No, he was looking to just chip it over the top.
Yeah, you could see
too much finesse.
You could see what was going through his mind. And it was the right thing to do. He must take those risks. He's a skillful player in the back half to deliver the ball. So it's just a costly one.
He was asking a lot of himself, though, wasn't he?
He does it week in, week out on the non-dominant side.
There's a bloke behind as well.
He could have just gone a little bit further to the boundary line. But anyway, Thompson's got it, who helped set up Smith's goal. So the acting captain, a big kick coming up. And Nathan Thompson kicks the goal. Hawks hang tough.
Bit of spirit there. We're getting over to Nathan Thompson, who's had a big month himself. And he's got some responsibility tonight. He started pretty well. His attack on it's been great. This is just when in doubt, you've got to take the safer option, don't you, and get it out of that danger area. Read that really well. Thompson stayed in the contest and finished it well. Important goal for the Hawks and an important goal for their acting captain.
Anthony Koutafidis.
Crowd went over to him, as suspected. Yeah, just too big and powerful for young Brennan in his first game, so why try and ask too much of the kid?
Everett, fingertips to it. Stevens steals it away. Centre clearance is Carlton 5, Hawthorn 0. Whitnell, juggled attempt at the mark, plays it to Johnson. Across it comes to Lappin, and he puts it out of bounds on the foot.
Well, yeah, Matthew Lappin started on the wing on his own. Chance Bateman left him there. I don't even reckon he looked at him as he ran down. You cannot leave Matthew Lappin or allow a player that skill and quality, that sort of room. He didn't have an opponent within 60 metres of him.
Bateman short. Reese has got it towards the opposite pocket. Margin 12 points. Counting down to quarter time. Interesting start, this one. Cruising past is Dixon. Reese told to play on. Good mark taken by Clark. Hit the ground. Immediately wanted to give the ball off, and they work it forward. The kick comes from Bateman around the outer side. Going back, Morrell. Did very well. Very good overhead. Squares it. Gets it there in time. Camparelli wants to go. Lappin Two experienced heads. Lappin kicks towards the 50. Whitnell should mark over the top. Hands to it. Didn't hang on. Well done by Houlihan. Runs inside the 50. That's better. Much better.
There is nothing wrong with that non-dominant side. That's the kind of skills you know he's capable of. And at the other end, that's why you'll accept that, yeah, he does take a risk occasionally. He can deliver like that on the non-dominant side. Once again, Whitnell's attack on the ball. Look, he hasn't had monstrous possessions here, Whitnell, but what he has done is charged at the ball, made a contest. He's actually led up Danny Jacobs to the ball on several occasions already.
Ryan Houlihan kicks his first and erases Thompson's goal from the record book.
Lappin involved. 18 points. Lappin involved again. Bateman's got to push up the ground with him. Cannot allow him easy possession like that.
Spider Everett gets the tap. Hodge going through. Stevens just goes to the ground. Got one high in the end. Umpire didn't see it. We'll have a bounce.
Yeah, he's on the wrong side. And Hodge, you could see him then. His left arm slipped over the shoulder.
Kudas
quickly Kudas took it off.
The quickest run of all time. Going to use him in spurts tonight.
But no one going on at the moment. Finally, Cade Simpson goes on. Pallas.
Oh, good boy.
Good play there by the debutant Brennan. Flicks it over the top. Bad bounce for Smith. Picked up by Stevens. Good hands. Here's the young fella, Simpson. Grabbed, thrown to the ground.
That'll hurt his head. Notice the better players in the heat then. Ones like Stevens had clean hands.
There's a very interesting scenario there. Kuda goes on for 3 minutes.
Everett.
Oh, good gather.
Roped his own tap in the end. Bounced back to him. The handball inside to Smith. There's a little bit of fumbling going on at the moment for the Hawks over the top. Scotland can run onto the ball. Usually a good disposal. Scotland has a bounce. Good Shepherd from behind. Makes it number three. Go all the way here, Scotland. Runs right up. Four bounces. Now he sets it up with a beautiful kick, but Lappin got to the front. Knocked it down. Whitnell kept his composure and his feet. Crow goes to the line. In the end, the Hawks had the numbers, but Lappin's leap was fantastic. Tony Jones, boundary side.
Well, Carlton would want to smarten things up off the field. That's twice tonight players have come off and no one's been ready to come on.
3 minutes. That would surprise you.
Hawthorn have got two ruckmen in the middle of the ground here. Robbie Campbell and Peter Everett.
I'm just wondering whether Kuda might have taken himself off.
Well, it seems that there was no one there ready for him to come back on. You suggest that's the case.
Whitnell. Mark the Hay kick. Goes to Stevens in the pocket for Vola. Well, Jonathan's kick coming out. Not too flash. And now for Vola, deep in the pocket. Jacobs on the mark.
A fair dready, that one coming off the top of his head.
No weight on the kick coming out. Favola's already got two. Almost quarter time. Very difficult shot, this one. Right full forward pocket for the right footer. Not a bad looking effort. That is a wonderful finish. That is so clinical. He's got three now, Brendan Favola.
Over the last 2 years, Brendan Favola, when he actually strikes the ball with his kicking action, his knee is staying straight. He used to sort of bend the knee and the ankle would come to the inside. Just made for, you know, inaccurate kicking. Now that's a real give up. And Jonathan Hay pays the price. His direct opponent kicks the goal before a turnover.
Kuda back on the ground too as we speak.
So two goals in 3 minutes and Carlton are back in action. 25 points. It's Carlton's best first quarter so far since round 14 last season. Houlihan again. It's not over yet. Off hands. There's Kuda. It's picked up by Ladson for the Hawks. 2.5 minutes left in the quarter. Thompson diving mark. Hawks badly need one here to stay in touch.
Good pace.
Plays on over to Loney. Loney now inside to Rees. Rees inside to Ladson. Ladson around the body. But pushed off the ball. Good play by Lekas. Couldn't quite hold the mark, though. Goes to ground. Second attempt to get it out to Barker. It spills out to Dixon. Over the line and out of bounds. Good pressure from the Carlton defence. We'll have a throw in 25 metres out from Hawthorn's goal.
Back on Kuda. He's been up and down, but he's back out there playing half forward. Loney, his opponent.
Again, more courage from Teague, too, coming back with a flight of it just moments ago. There's no fear. Everett in front. Beasy up, two of them. In effect, up with him. Socket off the ground by Lekas. It's bouncing around in there. Eventually comes to Johnson, falling to the ground. Gave it to Stevens. That was a little too cute. Scotland under pressure. Houlihan's got it now. It worked out okay. Next, Stevens. From half back, goes to the wing for Vola. Well, this will test him. He's on the wing. Played on brilliantly. Stevens.
Good run.
Running down towards half forward. Well, too casual in the end. A bit tired, maybe. Campbell chopped it off. Johnson brought him down. Knocked forward by Beasy. Opportunity there for Wiggins. Was he pushed in the back? Yes, he was. He'll get the free kick. He's 75 metres out from goal.
He did that well.
38 plays, 13. The Hawks need to hold here.
Wiggins' kick. Looking for Whitnall. Three up, no one down. Favola had the run of it. Then he fell over. Then he got up. Then he kicked it. Bounce, 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 bounce. Which way? It sits up for Norman. Slapped through for a rush behind. Minute left on the clock. Big minute for the Hawks. They have to hold here.
Can I pose a question? Why wouldn't it be holding the man on Crowe then? Because it wasn't in a marking contest. You're allowed to stretch the jumper away from his body when he runs back to tap the ball through.
Fair question. The other question you'd have if you're a Hawthorn coach is why three blokes flew with one Carlton player. Oh.
Good pressure from Barker. Thumped over the line and out of bounds. Throw in.
And one of those blokes being Jonathan Hay while Brendan Favola was crumbing it. There's Ian Dicker and John Kennedy look on.
Barbara Dicker chewing the old fingernails at the moment. Tough, tough for the Hawks at the moment. Big 47 seconds left. They cannot afford to concede another goal here. The Blues are full of running. Stevens. Held up.
Gee, they're really getting worked over around the stop plays here. Despite the fact that Peter Everett is getting his hands on the footy, Carlton have been dominant. You just wonder whether or not at times he's better off belting it forward and letting him run onto it. 12-5 clearances.
Three up for Carlton, two up that time.
Time for a score still as the ball squeezes along the boundary line. Two Hawks go at it. It's picked up by Lekas, who kicks from behind. Bateman's run was impeded. Ladson got it. Now he got it up to Bateman. Still time, 10 seconds. Need a mark here. The Hawks. Thompson let it bounce. Thumped away by a big Digby Morrell. It stays in play, and that should just about be it. We'll get the throw in, but that's it as Teague comes on with the bandage around his head after copping one. And a bit of claret being spilt. Peter Swab will go down and address his team. 26 points down at quarter time. And the Hawks have got plenty of work to do to get back into this game. That's it for the first quarter of footy. It was a beauty. They came out breathing fire, and the Blues were able to withstand it. Some fantastic play by Brennan Favola with three goals up forward. Means the Blues lead by 26 points, 6-3-39, 2-1-13 on Friday Night Football.
All on.
26 points the margin. Start of the second term. Friday Night Football. Beasy called upon. Campbell hooks it down. Beasy dives on top of it. Held to him. Another bounce.
Now this is where, even in this stat two here, Ed, they'll try and jump two or three up over Campbell.
Okay, Tony Jones, boundary side.
Yeah, well, just when that siren went for the end of the first quarter, Ed, Nathan Thompson took his players into the centre of the ground. They had their own powwow, and the message was simple. Just keep going, and keep your heads up.
Out of the middle, driven forward by Ball towards half forward. Awkward bouncing footy down there. Houlihan taken down. Lekas head over it. Backing out of the pack, Dixon. Slipped as he kicked. It bounces inside the 50. Thompson came hard. Teague, you know other way. Thompson goes again to Ball. Across it comes to Dixon. Kicks inside the 50.
Right.
Oh, great courage by Lappin. Got into the path of Spider. Spills to Bateman. Gets the goal.
I know you love it, Gary, and it pays off every time you say it. We seem to get the next kick into a forward line. It happens. A direct kick here goes to Spider Everett. And where is he? In the corridor of the ground. It requires two to spoil him. And make somebody's free.
And the other thing is, Dermot, that Bateman is Lappin's opponent. Now, we applauded Lappin's courage, but if you don't go with him, he's not accountable. So if Bateman hadn't been there, he wouldn't have been able to mop up. You've got to go up with Lappin.
So, they had the halftime huddle, they had all the talking and all the rest of it, and the Hawks have responded. They've got the first goal of the second quarter within a minute to trail by 20 points.
It's so important. Chance Bateman playing on Matthew Lappin. Matthew Lappin's courage was fantastic, but it was a two-on-one. It meant that Lappin had an opponent. Bateman ran with him. Bateman scores the goal.
Hodge trying to crash through.
Interesting to know this will be a ball. Oh, no, he's going to let it run.
Yeah, and he does. Too high. Ball gets the free kick. Advantage has been paid. Now brought back. Now advantage from the kick forward from Clark.
Just to watch for this one, when Prendergast goes up with a centre bounce, as soon as it's a secondary bounce, Lance Whitnell charges, makes up ground, and he is the ruckman thereafter for the shoulder-to-shoulder work.
McGrath was untidy. Ball was untidy as well. He set it up. Poulihan with nice soft hands, just knocked it forward. Picked up by Kuta. Well, beautiful handball outside to Whitnell. Long time since we've said that in the same breath. Kuta to Whitnell. And now to Stevens, the new chum. Looks up. Scotland is on. It's in a half forward. Long to wait if he wants to. Decides to go up the line.
He only did well to actually stop him playing on then.
Poulihan kicks to the hot spot over the head of Favola. They're all jumping in. Rees with nice hands. Gets it down to Hay. Well, he's kicked a torpedo that went about 10 metres. Obviously, the sore knees, Derm. It takes a long time coming back from the injuries in the... It's all right kicking at training. It's an altogether different thing out in the heat of battle.
Neil Young said it best. Rust never sleeps.
Yeah, it's a tempo thing, too.
Whitnell knocks it down. Wiggins. Across the shoulder. Gained about 10 metres. Johnson had it, lost it. Smith heads for the boundary line. Gets it across. Let's go down to the dock. Great to see him back.
Oh, it's on in the pocket.
We'll take over, Doc. Don't you worry about this. Didn't see what started it.
Rees has lost his jumper completely.
That can't be good.
He won't get reported. Can't take his number.
Meantime, back at the game, Loney. And the mark is taken out there by Beasley.
He's been loose at half-back since the start of the quarter. Beasley.
Beasley's got his jumper back, which is good news. There's Thornton. So that sparked up down in the pocket. 20 points the margin, early going second term. Thornton, McGrath, looking okay. Kicks towards the 50. Fisher is surrounded down there. Brennan was up in front. Camporelli gets the crumb. Kicks from 50. Hangs a long time in the air. Favola, something out of nothing. Four goals to Favola.
Ben, Justin. Fantastic effort to stand under the footy and contest it when it's a shocking kick in, control the ball to the front, and then the cat-like reflexes. Have a look at this. Just bang it on the boot. That is goal sense and class and just magnificent. Yeah. Anyone that would think of trading him to Ben Income.
Brennan Favola shows why he's a franchise player at the Carlton Football Club. Look at this.
Watch how Johnny just eases back there for a second. Now, that's tempo as well. See, he just eased back off his body pressure once he spoiled the ball. Brennan Favola seized on that one split second when Johnny let go the body pressure.
I don't think Kelvin Moore would have stopped that one, Derm. He was just fantastic. Got it out. Again, Hodge has been good, but back in Camporelli was offloaded. Good, tough stuff in there at the moment. It spills out wide. Here's a chance now off the back of the pack for Bowyer to Lappin. Lappin now looks up, kicks out in front of Fisher. Fisher and Brennan. Did it well. Picked it up. Handball over the top to McGrath. The old don't argue. Kicked it forward.
Picked up by Dixon of Hawthorn. Gets it over to Hay. Doesn't want to kick. Heads to the boundary line. Throw in, and it's on off the ball again for Vola. Just letting Hay know all about it. Carlton fans say, what about the throw of Favola? That is over the boundary line. And
That's good for footy.
Carlton fan, just lets you know he's kicked four, Brendan Favola.
Yes.
That's what it was.
He's got his work cut out. He is red hot, Brendan Favola. It's a hard task for someone coming back after such an absence from footy. But they are giving him plenty of room. And he's rewarding them.
Had to get technical, but Jonathan Hayes got very big shorts tonight. I think it was the parachute effect as he was coming down. He stayed up longer.
That is technical.
Head pass from Scotland. Ooh.
Oh, that's free.
Loney was taken high. Ball up in the pocket. Let's go back to the dock.
Yeah, Dennis, just to mention that Cooter played 8 minutes of the first quarter. Carlton being very conservative tonight because they felt that he came up far too sore after last time playing 100 minutes. So you'll just watch him conservatively tonight.
Well, nobody touched the football. Hodge, deep in his own defensive area, jams it on the boot, heads for the boundary line. It runs across at left half back.
Now, the umpires have to pick this up. Prendergast actually went in, feigned he was going to be the ruckman, shepherded Everett away from the ball, and it's Whitnell who actually attends the ruck tap out.
Yep.
It's a pure shepherding exercise.
A lot of thought, you would think, has gone into this. Everett in front. Prendergast hooks it down behind, though, successfully.
Oh, steal.
Scotland bumped off it. Smith dragged down into the path of Clark. He hit the deck as well. Kitafiti's applied the tackle, and the crowd loved that. Ball up right half forward.
I'll tell you what
is,
it now.
Is good is that Carlton wouldn't have known how souped up Hawthorn were, and their attack on the footy, their tackling, and it's been absolutely first rate.
Dennis Pagan team, mate. They're not going to come out any other way.
No, you got to hand it to them.
Scotland was fantastic. Got it out of the centre or the bounce there to Lappin, who nearly killed. He crunched through him, missed him. Picked up by Big Spider. That's good play. Handball's over the top. Here's a chance. Bateman over the top to the running Loney. Loney looks up, kicks it long to full forward. Thompson gets back. Now it spills out the back to Williams. Open goal opportunity, and he nails it. Goal to Williams.
Get it in long. Get it in long again and quick. Get it in towards Nathan Thompson, who's got some sort of height and physical advantage over Thornton, and make sure that there's someone close enough should the ball come to ground. And it's not scientific, but the last two times it's worked. And just create some uncertainty in the defenders' minds. Let them worry about what happens if they don't clear the area. First touch for Williams.
Mark Williams hasn't seen much of it. Camporelli on top. Well, interesting manoeuvre.
Well, he submitted pretty quick.
Steiner recliner, a variation on him. Back in the middle. Everett wins it down yet again. Prendergast back to Everett. Claimed immediately. Somehow got the arms free. Ball in trouble. Oh, that is a hard ball get. We'll have a bounce down towards half forward.
Chance Bateman's finding a fair bit of the footy. If you were Carlton at the moment, you'd be looking at just trying to put a clamp on him. Seven possessions at the moment, but most of his have been constructive going forward.
McGrath has tactics on Spider having an effect. It bounces down towards the attacking 50. Taken by Scotland. Bit happening off the ball as the kick wanders down towards the pocket for Vola. Magnificent.
He caught it like a tennis ball, didn't he?
Yep. I watched him all the way through them. He actually swatted Jonathan Hay away. Umpire's pretty close. See the distance between the two there. He did something pretty tricky. He actually tripped up Jonathan and took his body away, and he got a bit of a run on from him. And then just with the space, able to hold him away in the end.
Centre clearances, Carlton 7, Hawthorn 0. Johnson's got 3. The bowler's third mark inside the 50, lining up at his fifth goal, coming off 7 last week. His best effort against the Hawks, 4, round 21 last season. He's got 43 for this season, 63 last year. You'd like him from here. 35 metres out. Can't do it. Can't beat me.
It was... You're very good at it, Dennis. It was just a stage for Brendan Favola, a hurdle to get over. Once he became or becomes a seriously good body player, he's a 100-goal full forward, because he's got all the leads and got all the tricks that way.
Loney to himself, and then the long kick. Crowed went up without the ball, or came down without the ball. Spider Everett in there as well. And we'll watch and see what happens when Spider does the ruck work on this occasion. Triple teaming against Everett, just knocking the ball forward.
Well, you've got Prendergast and Whitnell both in the vicinity. Dixon will try and keep Prendergast away here.
The clearances and the breaks have been all Carlton tonight. There's a line ball, that one. Comes out to Dixon eventually. So the Hawks win that clearance. Off hands, we'll have another go at it on centre wing. 12 and a half minutes left. A nest of Hawks in the suits, unable to play tonight.
Richie Vandenberg in the middle of the screen. Campbell Brown next to him. Simon Beaumont.
Yep. Lance Piccioni in amongst it as well, who are all rubbed out during the week. Throw in. Everett gets the tap.
One-on-one, he'll be able to do that every time.
Leckis to Smith. High up and under to the half-forward flank. Up they go. Off hands. Here's a chance for Spider. Rode that beautifully. Found some space and then kicks it long. Looking for Williams. Up he goes. Brings the ball to the ground. Has another go at it. Ladson's in there as well. Now Williams has another crack at it. Lippery. Keeps falling over. Picked up by Scotland. He's thrown to the ground. Digby Morrell under pressure. Thompson, strong body. Ladson still there. Now it's Hodge. Hodge flicks it over the top. Williams again, thrown to the ground. Picked up by Morrell, who heads to the boundary line and finds it. Into the Crazy John sign. We'll have a throw in at half forward flank.
Good pressure as Johnny Hay takes a seat. Brendan Favola's got Trent Crowe for company now.
I think that's all right. He's just got to let Johnny understand the tempo again. He's a gun player. He's had a taste of it. He's been towed up a bit, but just let him settle down now.
Beasley from behind knocked it down decisively to Camporelli. Kicks towards the wing. Lappin has been very good.
What's the trouble with Chance at the moment? He's getting a bit, but this bloke is so dangerous.
He's taking a few. Ricochets off Chance Bateman on the mark. Gives it back, though. Lappin away. A high bounce, a secondary bounce, goes beautifully to half-forward and Teague. Dropping back is Whitnell. Is he going at goal? I think he is. Whitnell is running back. Well, what was that? 50 cents each way of behind.
And it's a break, Spider Everett. He was 20 metres out with Lance Whitnell and needed to go to the goal line and couldn't muster the energy to go back there.
First behind in David Teague's career. He's kicked four goals straight in his 44 games of football to that moment.
Was he shooting at goal? I guess he was.
Look at Spider here. He's only 20 metres from the kick. He can't run out far enough to be a target. So this creates some confusion for the next one. There you go.
There's good kicking in from Jacobs to Leckis.
He's looking to the bench. Spider, and he says, I want a break.
Leckis up the line. Nice kick. Mark taken there by Brennan. The boy from Horsham, his fifth disposal on debut tonight.
He's going okay.
Getting close to the man on the mark.
Pick eight in the 2002 draft. Goes up the line. Thompson flies off hands. Good play by Ladson, just knocked it forward. Picked up by Bowyer, the former Hawk. Finishes up with Stevens at halfback. Plenty of blues, good kick.
Oh.
Picked it out nicely. Simpson. Steps around Spider, then slips over. Good play by Everett. Now Loney can break, but there's no one to kick to. There is no one forward of Loney. He just has to kick to space and hope somebody can get across. In the end, Hodge was the only player forward of Loney who picked it up backward of centre.
Good effort.
They're mucking around with a bit, Carlton, here at the moment.
They're actually playing a pretty taxing game, Carlton. You'll find that later in the quarters, they'll seize up a bit. They try and get it running here. They're playing a bit of a paddock.
Prendergast down towards half forward. Lapping over the football. Worked off the line of it.
Super.
Camporelli went in strongly. Simpson. Yeah. Gang tackle taken down.
Rees unlucky not to get one from the back.
He was. Nick Stevens had a lot of the footy in the first quarter. Ball came off on.
Oh, he's pulled one out here, the umpy.
And it's gone to Stevens now. And he's kept into a couple of touches this quarter.
Camporelli's got the free. Not sure why. Was it holding the ball? May have been. Camporelli's got it in any case. Well, here's trouble.
Trent Crowe's a new opponent. Now, Trent would have to be aware that anywhere from 60 metres, Brendan Favola's dangerous. Most other players you wouldn't kick it to in that situation.
Now, watch that one, Gary. He actually double-led him. He turned and run back. Trent went with him, and he just wrong-footed him, came back again to the 50-metre line.
He just...
Yeah, well, that's fair. It's good, good forward.
Let's have a look at the replay here, and we believe that just off the ball there, Reece just gave a little cheap shot to the guts. There's nothing much in it.
Yeah.
But that was it. And a goal opportunity now for the Blues because of that.
Geez, he kicks him a long way, this bloke.
Yep. He'll kick from about 55 here. Pavola gives it a ride across the face, this one. They compete about 5 metres out, and Spider lifts again. Punches it across the line, forcing it behind.
Let's have a look at this again, this free kick. Now, standing up, Camparelli gives the initial shove and a little one back, and that's just
ridiculous.
Yes, you can't do that.
Nah, it must have been for verbals. And you wouldn't that pay
was
that.
It. That was it, Doom.
Could not pay that.
He did.
No. I'm not copping that. No. That won't be it.
It was. They mic'd up, remember?
Confirmation from our mics that that was it, Doom. Believe it or not.
You're kidding.
Yeah, that was it.
Mark Graham and Shane Crawford. 23 points down the Hawks, almost their score.
But not gone. Next goal is the crucial goal of this game, you feel. Off the boot of Camparelli there, unfortunately, for him running past. Free kick. Clark brings it inside to Ball, two sons of guns over the years. To Crowd, who's run a long way. One step too far.
You better run back quick now because there's one man in Carlton.
Favola's all on his own. Norman's got it. He hands it off. Oh. No, the umpire wants him to kick over the mark.
It was about three steps too far. You could see that he knew if
Favola
he bounced.
Still on his own. Still on his own. Still on his own. Still on his own. Now someone comes to him and he's got it anyway. Umpire said it was a bump ball.
Yeah, unfortunate. He did everything right there, Brendan.
Look at this. Got the sit, beautiful mark, and just bounced off his noggin and onto the ground.
Good decision by the umpire.
There's the bounce right on the 50. Trent passed him on the way back. Hand pass comes to McGrath. High ball towards the kickoff line. In front, Lappin. Fisted away down there by Tallis, roving the pack, Clark. Little 1-2. And eventually they work it out to Reece. Jacobs involved there. Now they've bought themselves some time on the wing. This is Smith. Goes down towards Hartford. Morrell stands his ground. Takes a good mark.
It's where they're falling down big time. Carlton getting numbers back across their half-back line. And Hawthorn just haven't got a target there.
Johnson on the wing. Former Hawk. The margin 23 points. As Ed said, the next goal very important. Kicks down towards the attacking 50. Lappin sandwiched between two Hawks. His advantage paid. Scotland goes to the pocket and finds Favola. It's coming back.
It's a Hawk free kick.
It's a Hawthorn free kick against Lappin.
True Crowe's grandfather played for the All Blacks. Think he had a flashback then and just thought he'd go for the try line.
You could see he was thinking, I'm not clear enough to bounce it yet.
You got to know what he was thinking.
Had to unload.
I'm going to run to Fremantle. There goes the kick on the outer side. Offhand, Barker. Down towards the attacking 50. Bowyer in front. Williams, timely bump. In goes Teague. Williams dives on top of it. And I think he'll be pinged. No, help to him, says the umpire.
Yeah, good call.
And a good result because he's outnumbered again. A lot of footy gone to Carlton in the last 10 minutes. Probably haven't made it pay on the scoreboard, but at least now Hawthorn can get some numbers down their forward line.
Yep, excellent umpiring there. Ball does it nicely. Then the kick. Didn't have much on. He just kicked it to the hot spot. Stevens got back, and the Blues are doing that with courage, running back into the path and doing it nicely. Bowyer gets it out to Houlihan from defensive 40. He kicks into the centre of the ground. Big play here. Teague kept his feet, did enough, but picked up by Smith. Smith shows the ball to his opponent and then kicks a high up and under. Here comes Thompson. Up he goes, crashes the pack. Off hands, Reece. Into the open goal goes Ladson. That's an important goal. And Thompson brought it to ground. His first. That's a big play for the Hawks.
Nathan Thompson's effort there was every bit as important as any mark or kick or anything else, because again they are outnumbered, but at least his attack on the footy caused a quality spill.
Now look at Reece's vision through the traffic. Yeah, he actually started loading that handball. He jumped with 2 feet to accept it. He started loading the handball before he returned back down to terra firma.
He's got to get some numbers, the Hawks, around half forward.
Yep.
Hawthorn, three of the last four goals in this one now. 7-6, 5-1. Bit of a rally. Rees with very quick hands. Setting it up. Lanson, four goals on the season now. His first tonight. Approaching halftime, Friday night football. Hawthorn sticking around. Prendergast stands off. He can't ruck. Knocked forward by Everett. Opportunity for Johnson. Tries to get it. On the boot, nothing doing. Clark over the football and we'll have a bounce.
He's been good tonight, Dermot Clark, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's had it nine times. He's got a run with
Camporelli.
Roll with Scotty Camporelli.
He's only had seven.
He's just on the left-hand side of screen. Spider Everett, 19 hit out so far. Watch for the third man up. Trying to get free, they are, to come over the top.
Everett. Ooh. Beats DeLuca, thumped it down. Teague, slick hand pass. Somewhere in the congestion, controlled there by Loney, gave it to Everett, kicks inside the 50. Well done by Bowyer, angles the fist towards the boundary line. Clever by Thornton, into the path of Stevens. He's got company, taken down by Ladson. And the ball up in the pocket as we go back to the dock.
Yeah, Dennis, a fairly relaxed Anthony Koutafidis tonight. He came off the 11-minute mark of this quarter, having started, just sitting on the bike, keeping the hamstring warm in the dugout next to Carlton. So he's got a big smile on his face, so... pretty happy with the way the team's going.
What about Lance down there, Pete?
Yeah, just a rotation. He's been working pretty hard. He started pretty hard early in the game, as you know. They're just sort of easing him off, giving him a breather.
Here come the Hawks. The ball spills out to Tallis. A thumping kick inside Everett from the side. Up he goes. He's got it.
He will end up being the most important player on the ground, Peter Everett. As the game wears on, fatigue starts to kick in. This bloke here hasn't got... anyone out on the park in the opposition that can go with him. So he's just got to be able to hang in there, stick in there, and he can turn this whole thing on its head.
First mark for the night to Spider Everett. Last week he had 10 disposals. He had 39 hit-outs and kicked two goals. He is deadly at the goals. Spider needs to kick this one. He pierces the middle of the goals, and the Hawk spirit is starting to show itself at the Telstra Dome.
Kuta returns to the field now. They really need a centre bounce clearance here, the Carlton team, just to settle their team down at the moment. But one thing I made call a few minutes ago, you notice they had about 15 men inside, within 55 metres of their defensive goal, Carlton. They're playing a taxing game. And as the quarters wear on, Hawthorn looked best at the end of both the opening quarters.
Margin back to 11 points. And the Blues keep throwing different looks at Spy. The last time it was DeLuca and Prendergast. Now Koutafidis in there with DeLuca, who comes on the angle. But still, Everett got it down. Smith hand passes the ball forward. Over the football, Koutafidis. Everett doing it all at the moment. Bateman couldn't control it. Stevens. Bateman put down by a lateral arriving weight.
It's just turned. It has for Hawthorn. Osborne's getting under a bit of skin. Now, just got to get another one-on-one contest in there, forward 50.
Now, this is good. See, he's fighting two of them. That means one Hawthorn player is free somewhere. You've got to get away. If you're a Carlton player like that, you have to get away and find the loose man off.
He's the future of the family club. Osborne. They're the Osborne family now.
That's what you don't want, is to try to pinpoint a short pass when you've got some momentum, kick it long to a contest.
Hopefully Dixon. They're not as dysfunctional, Ed.
Dixon gave it to Morrell. Lappin puts it across the boundary line on the full. Mistakes from both teams. It's been a tough, uncompromising game, and fatigue close to halftime affecting performance now.
Dance Bateman is finding the footy.
Yep. The defensive side of the wing, under 3 minutes till halftime.
The lead has to come out to this flank.
Bateman plays on, steps around Prendergast. Probing kick inside the 50. Oh! Big leap down there. Thompson couldn't hang on. Rees gives it to Ball. Chips it down towards the kickoff line. It has not been touched. It hit the post.
Big finish. Game.
Having a dig now. Russell Green there, father of...
You just got to love this from Nathan Thompson.
3-on-1.
You can do that all night and you'll be the most valuable forward on the ground without even getting your hands on it.
We saw it last week. McDougall did it in the first half and he was invaluable.
Two-pack contest to Thompson have resulted in a goal and a behind, or a poster at least. And look, a big Spider.
They're playing dead at the moment, Carlton. They're playing such a taxing game. 16 blokes run into the back line and then they try and run out with it. at about the 20 mark, minute mark of each quarter, they're going a bit flat. That'll work.
Spiders kick as a mongrel off the boot. It spills nicely though to Williams, who gives it off. Here's a chance for the Hawks again. Ladson just pushed up the ball. Now DeLuca's on. They've got plenty for bowlers all on his own. He's all on his own. Now he takes the mark. He's 55 out. There's no one inside 50. He can bounce it through if he wants. He does. He lines it up. He kicks. Well, it bounces. It bounces. It's a goal. Big Fev has kicked another one. Five for the night before halftime.
Well, you just got to sit back and find out where Trent Craig was in that play. He probably pushed forward.
It was in the zone. They set up a zone against it.
At some stage, you've got to roll the dice, and then you've got to make the decision. In fact, it ended up being, as the ball went into Hawthorn's forward line, Trent was out watching, and he ends up standing the mark.
So the margin, 16 points. In the last 7 minutes, inside 50s favour Hawthorn, 7-1.
That's the one.
That's the one, a telling one. Brendan Favola from long range, his fifth goal. So we're back in the middle. Look at that. Valiant attempt. Dislodging the goal umpire's cap, if you don't mind. And Everett has been sensational in the last 15 minutes or so. In fact, for the game, but in particular, his efforts in recent times. Reese got it from Smith down towards half forward. Bowyer coming back with the flat of the ball. It's knocked deep into attack there for Hawthorn by Wiggins. Picked up by Teague. Swings it to the boundary. Koutafidis takes the mark. Under a minute 30 remaining in this opening half. Koutafidis hasn't seen much of it. Goes down towards half forward. Jacobs in from the side. Got a fist on it. Taken away by Smith. Kept his composure. Comes to Hodge. Is there a late goal left in this one? Hodge too cute by half. And the mark is taken by Morrell.
Hodge and Dixon both trying to pinpoint kicks going forward. Both times they've been turned over.
A minute to go in the first half. Friday night football. Entertaining affair, this one. And Morrell taking plenty of time. Puts it up. Lappin will fly from behind. Knocked away by Tallis, though. And across the line, and Lappin is coming off with 45 seconds remaining. Whitnell comes back on.
Okay, 46 seconds doesn't seem like a long time in football. It is a vital three quarters of a minute here. Still time for a score. The Blues can pinch one here. They will be delighted. It'll set the whole game up for them. They can play a second half defensive play. In comes Koutafidis. He's done it. He's found Whitnell. Here comes the goal. This could be the biggest kick of the match. And Big Lance has kicked the point.
Oh, gee whiz. He sensed that, Lance Whitnell. You should have seen him peel out the back door as soon as he saw clear possession go to Kuta.
Well, you just can't do that if you're the defence of Hawthorn. You can't have Favola dropping back and Whitnell dropping back like that into 30 metres of space. It just says that someone's been done.
Still time. This will be a free kick if it rolls over. No, just touched in time by Hodge it was, who brought it back in. 15 seconds. Off the ground. Good play by Hodge. He kept going. Last chance for the Hawks. Thompson comes out. Held up. Good play by McGrath. He's kicked it straight into Spider's head. He's doing everything, Spider, out there at the moment. He's stopping him with his noggin. Kicking goals, taking marks, and that'll be the score at halftime. And we have got a beauty on Friday night football. Last play of the half. And Brendan Favola has kicked the last three goals of the game for the Blues. Spider gets another tap. It's spilled open for Dixon, but that's it for the first half of footy, and it was an absolute cracker. Well, Doom, you'd be happy with the spirit that's been shown by the Hawks so far. They kicked 4-2 in that second term to get right back in it. Only 17 points the difference when we come back for the second half of football. Dermot and Gary will have a good look at what happened in that first half during our halftime break. Favola has 5. And let's have a look at the Hawks as they go to the centre to reaffirm their own spirit before they speak to their coach. We'll be back right after this on Friday Night Football. Carlton 8-7-55, lead Hawthorn 6-2-38. Welcome back, Friday Night Football. The passion, the excitement, the superstar players. That's why the crowds turn out every week to see this great game of football. We've got a beauty on our hands too. 17 points the difference at halftime. The Hawks have got a bit of work to do. The Blues fought back. Brenna Favola with 5 goals is the man. And Dennis Pagan just has that little break at the moment to defend going into the third quarter. Let's go down to Tony Jones with the injured Hawthorn skipper, Shane Crawford.
Well, Shane, we saw you in the...
Yes, Tony.
Well, Shane, we saw you in the rooms there having a bit of a chat at halftime. You've got to be careful about that sort of stuff, don't you? But what were you saying?
Oh, no, I was just giving the guys a bit of feedback on their role for tonight and just making sure that they stick to their tasks. So, you know, we worked our way back into it, and I think, you know, we just need to try and win this quarter and then we're right into it.
Well, you looked gone there, didn't you? And then Spider stood up and he's really taken charge of things.
Yeah, you know, Spider stood up and a few others started to, you know, I thought Nathan... although he probably didn't get as much of the ball as he'd like, he started to, you know, break up a few packs and really got us going a bit. So, you know, I think we're right in this.
But while he's a plus for you, Brendan Favola's a big negative, isn't he, for Hawthorn?
Every time he's got the ball, he seems to slot them through. So hopefully he'll have a slow half this half. And, you know, we hopefully get a few easy goals. We work pretty hard for our goals, whereas the Carlton side have, you know, seem to have got some pretty easy goals. So... you know, we've got to work on that and get back into the match.
All right, just quickly, how are you travelling?
I'll be travelling really well if we can get up and win this.
All right, good on you. Back to you, guys.
Thanks, Tony. Good on you, Shane. Dr. Peter Larkins before we start the second half.
Yeah, just again, only Kuta to talk about tonight. No serious injuries out of the game so far. And Kuta about 15 minutes out of the second quarter, 8 minutes the first quarter, Ed. So just easing back into it. They'll use him, I'm sure, during the third quarter at some stage.
OK, let's go. Dennis Cometti to start the second half. The Hawks trailing Carlton now by 17 points. We're in for a beauty. Second half on Friday Night Footy.
Joel Smith going to Lance Whitnell, which is a good attacking move from Peter Schwab.
Another new look inside the centre square. Three smaller players. And Beasy running at Everett. Everett knocks it forward, down towards half forward. Coming across on the angle is Bowyer. Interesting kick, goes about 25 metres. Tracking it back, Bateman, a good player in the opening half. Pulls it back towards the middle. Thompson.
What a kick.
He can play chance, Bateman. He had a couple of light weeks. He was very good against Fremantle 3 or 4 weeks ago. And tapered off against Adelaide. He had a few mates. And did he, dare I say it, fly the flag last week?
He's up out of the back pocket, playing in the middle. He's had Matthew Lappin for most of the night, but now finds himself with Cade Simpson. Not sure whether that'll last for too much longer.
Thompson going at his second.
Fair view there.
Yeah, he's got the angle. We've got the angle. Riding on his shoulder, Thompson sends it goalward. It's okay. Wonderful start for the Hawks.
Good pressure on Carlton applied by the Hawks there when they just won the ball in the backside, in their back side of the centre circle here. Ball just popped up in the air. Glennie Bowyer, not a great kick on his non-dominant side. Had more time to do better than that.
Now, Lance is taking Joel Smith back to the goal square. There's Thompson with Thornton. He's got a physical advantage, so he still looms as a danger man.
Hawks have kicked 5 of the last 7 goals since quarter time.
And young Luke Ball will be the target player for Spider here.
Hodge?
No, at the back.
At the back it comes. In comes Clark on the left boot. Kicks it up, looking for Thompson again. It's punched away from him. Dixon tries to squeeze the ball out. Ball. That's Matthew Ball, of course. Going to the ground was Wiggins.
At their first ball up, as we look at the Carlton bench where Kuta sits, along with Prendergast, Norman and Wade, Spider put the big fist into it, which just changed things up and took it out of the square. And the next one he went backwards, so they're mixing it up.
Spider has to contend with 2. The umpire's seen it at last, and Everett will get the free kick for holding in the ruck duel.
And this is where they've got to open it out for Thompson.
Johnny Hayes playing up forward now.
Hayes the lead. He gets to the front of the pack. Here's Clark in the pocket. Wants to get it over the top. He does. It stays a long time for Hayes. He tries to crash through. He gets the kick on the play. Good play by Camporelli. Ran it down. Under pressure from Hodge. He was taken down. The kick didn't clear the 50. Now a chance for the Hawks again. Loney in there. Picked up though nicely by Bowyer. Under pressure. Spiders fighting hard for it. He's grabbed and taken to the ground. We'll have a bounce. This is great football. Good hard stuff. Nothing scientific about it at the moment. Plenty of guts and determination. Ball up 35 metres out from the Hawthorn goal.
What Johnny Hay in at full forward has done is pulled Digby Morrell, another tall man up forward, away from centre half back, where he was actually reading the play pretty well and being a stopper.
Bounce. Everett Hill. Surely. No free kick. Doesn't matter. Bateman gets his second.
He is going all right at the moment, Chance.
Yeah, he's got, as I said, Cade Simpson. I don't think that's going to last for too much longer. But, look, again, it's the Everett factor. He will get better and better. He hasn't got too many mates on Dick at the moment. He might get some in a minute if they keep kicking goals. But, look, that's the advantage you've got, so you've got to make it work for you. And now that they've got Hay down there, they've got the option of bringing Campbell on at some stage. And if Everett went forward, well, that'd test the Carlton back line.
Take a chance on me. Spider knocks it forward. And Bateman into the open goal for his second. Clearances this quarter. Four in 4 minutes to the Hawks. They couldn't get near it in the first half. Suddenly Chance has got something to act to. He's got the soapy star name, Chance Bateman. And now he's putting in the Ron Moss performance as well. Hamming it up there in the square. In goes Brawley's held up. We'll have a bounce. It's 5 points the difference. Ian Dicker on his own. There's nothing worse coming out of those president's lunches, I can tell you. The presidents are out the front waiting. The others are eating their scones, and they all walk on your feet and jump in front of you when you're trying to watch the third quarter of the footy. That's when the binoculars come in handy, Des.
Everett dominating. Down to ball to Loney. Kicks inside the 50. Thompson once more. Bounces off his chest and goes 20 metres. And taken high. It's going to be a free kick to Osborne.
Fortunate. He ducked ahead then. He really did duck it. He knew he had to sit under it.
60 metres out. Spears a pass to Lekas.
Oh!
What a start by the Hawks in this third term.
They haven't been in front since the opening 5 minutes when they scored a behind. This to hit the front for the first time since then, Dennis.
Coming up for his 10th disposal, averaging 16 a game this season. A high of 28 against the Kangaroos back in round two. A low of 8 against Fremantle round 8. Important kick. This for the lead. Lekas sets it up. It's accurate. Hooks in front.
Dennis Plagan just cannot allow Callum Beasy to go in the centre bounce ruck anymore. He just can't do it. The boy's about 6'3", which is a big man, but it ain't big enough to go with Spider Everett. Now, that's a lucky one. He did attempt to lay it the right way, Wiggins, and he did duck into it, Osborne. He's told by Everett then next to him, turn around quickly. Lekas is by himself.
Point the difference. Disposals this quarter, Hawthorn have had 12 for 3 goals. Carlton, this is only their 4th for the quarter from Scotland. They finally get it forward to the centre. Can the Blues come back? They try by a point. Back to Scotland. Suddenly it's all Hawthorn and Everett gets it out again. Everett over to Loney. A thumping kick up the what? Centre half forward. Thompson being held. It was back heeled. What about that? Maradona stuff coming
out
there by Thornton. Now it's up the other end again, but a strong mark taken by Jacobs. This game's got everything. Clearances since quarter time. 18-5 to Hawthorn. And it has been a turnaround.
And it's forced them to put Lappin back now, Carlton. So just they're in the driver's seat right now, Hawthorn.
Jacobs out wide. This is Barker. Lays it up. Bateman playing inspired football from the wing. Kicks it towards the 50. At the back and working Hodge. In on the angle. Morrell upended. Hay pushed off the line of the football. And they tie it up right on the 50. Crashing in hard was Wiggins.
Yeah, he meant it.
Amazing.
He meant it. How good is it? Yeah, good, great call.
Watch this. Watch this, though. This is really our spider's done all his work. Look at the ball use, or the ball possession here.
Norman over the top, knocked it down, but straight to Loney. They'll compete about 25 metres out. No competition. Lappin took a very good grab.
Yeah, big job for Osborne as a defensive forward. They just cannot allow Matthew Lappin to start to control things in his back half.
Camporelli, right half back. DeLuca back on the ground. He's with Everett.
They just got to get it up. They've got to get it into the hands of big Brendan Favola. They've got to work it inside 50.
Thornton, awkward half volley. Gets by Thompson. Aided by a good Shepherd. Short McGrath, but they're locked in their back half at the moment. That's ambitious. Oh. Under pressure. Got a kick off. Morrell, good overhead. Almost the mark. Spills to Scotland. He breaks from half back. Spires Lappin running hard. Great block by Norman. Kicked inside the 50. And the mark is taken down there by Houlihan. About 45 out. Lappin, moments ago, had it deep in defence.
He ran hard then.
Yeah, he's the man they have to watch, Matthew Lappin. And I think you'll find that Stephen Green has just wandered onto the field and that will be his focus.
Short one is on, and guess who?
Yep, and I watched that all the way, and that was beautiful shielding. And the Carlton player that gave him the chop out was Glennie Bowyer, a good mate of Trent Croats. He actually took a step into his line. We do have the camera trained on Brendan at the moment, so we might get some vision of that in a moment. But it was beautiful teamwork there by the Carlton teammate just to take Trent Croats away from the trailing lead.
Hawks lead by a point. This to regain the lead for the Blues. Going at number six. Again, almost in 3D. Favola, distance will not be a problem. And the accuracy is there as well. He slots another one. Six on the night.
It was interesting to watch on the initial steps of that lead by Brendan Favola. He basically ran a semicircle. Watch him here. He goes around Glennie Bowyer. Says, take him for me, Glennie Bowyer. And, yeah, well, Glennie Bowyer's opponent had to do more than that then.
Well, it's a thing, isn't it? It's a craft back there. Someone's got to make the decision to go and stand 10 or 15 metres in front.
Carlton fight back. It's the Brendan Favola show. Boys, just take us through this, Derm.
Yeah, Glenn Bowyer, eyes not for the ball, just takes Trent away from it. I can't see who the Hawthorn player
was. It's young Brendan, Derm, who is his first game, so it's a bit harsh, but he had to peel off when it was going to be a collision and take the dangerous spot in front of Favola.
Favola has kicked the last four goals for the Blues. From the 26-minute mark of the first quarter right through to this moment in time. He's kicked six for the game. The last four of the game for the Blues to keep him in it. They lead by five as Lappin boots it out wide. Wiggins racing for the ball. Lekas is there. The boundary beats them both. Oh, what a game. Brendan Favola is turning on tonight. Six goals. Big Lance is out there. He needs to get in amongst it now, Lance, for the Blues.
Matthew Lappin has gone to defence. He's rebounded the last three balls inside 50 for Hawthorn. He's the bloke that's taken it out three times.
Lance will kick goals or he won't touch it because of Joel Smith. He's the opponent now. He's taken him to the goal square. This will go over the boundary. Yeah, they don't want Joel Smith rebound running off half back. So Lance will take him all the way to the goal square.
Carlton's just won four of 16 games played at the Telstra Dome, which wouldn't make it any easier for Ian Collins, the boss here. The worst record in the league. But it has been a horror couple of years for the Blues as Scotland was being held and will get the free kick. Wow, how about that? That's Toyota Skycam.
Well, Prendergast is away. Hasn't spotted him yet.
So Scotland has it on centre wing. They're short with the kick. Puts it out in front of Favola. Couldn't quite hold it. Dixon keeps his feet. Now he goes down. Favola's going to grab this. Picked up by Smith. Great play and the Hawks are away.
Across the body. Hangs a long time in the air. Stevens. Clever. Scotland. Bowyer. Three of their recruits. Only as far as Dixon. Game in the balance. Bateman, who's been terrific, feeds it forward. On the other side, Ball. Kicks long towards half forward. Bateman. Or rather, Barker got his hand to it. Teague at the back, tidies up, pulls the kick, bounces it to Norman. Norman looks down towards half forward. Whitnell slipped over. And he's going to get a free kick, is he? Will advantage be paid? It's paid. Johnson, slow. Now the umpire, equally as slow, blows the whistle. And it's coming back to Whitnell.
Gee, that was a free kick, wasn't it?
No, he's on the ball, though.
They still got him high.
Yeah, he did.
Whitnell
to DeLuca.
Yeah.
Now, Peter Everett had gone down to fill the hole. This is what happens when you've got a dominant forward like Favola. Whitnell went down to stand in front of Brendan Favola. Now, what happens sometimes, a dumb ruckman then don't go and just sneak in. But in this situation, well, often happens. They go, oh, yeah, my man's down there. I won't go. I mean, DeLuca got proactive, got into the hole. Now he's got a shot at goal.
Three career goals. Kudafidis is back on. DeLuca kicking from about 40. Huge kick in the context of this game.
That's home.
It is. Straight through the middle. Been watching for Bowler.
They've answered the challenge here. It's a terrific game of footy now. They've really settled well. And that's a good sign from Adrian DeLuca because, you know, you can spectate. This is Trent.
That's a free.
He's having his hands full down there, Trent, at the moment. Now, this is DeLuca just slotting into a gap left by Peter Everett, who went to do what most ruckmen do and sit in front of the opposition forward. It's just good, smart footy.
So for the first time since late in the first quarter, the Blues have been able to put back-to-back goals on the board. DeLuca ending a run of four in a row for Favola. Inside 50s this quarter, Hawthorn 7 for 3 goals. Carlton 2 for 2 goals. That's efficiency. Fisher on hands and knees. The Blues have fought back well, taking the sting out of the game when you just thought that the Hawks were going to run over the top. Great play. As the Carlton skipper in there, Anthony Kudafidis, what a superstar he has been. Coming back from injury, he takes Clark to the ground. Ball up.
Now, Luke DeLuca here, and this will be the attempted third man up over the top in Prendergast.
There it is. Down to Wiggins. Oh. They read it well. Wiggins just couldn't get enough on it. Picked up by Dixon. His kick to half-forward. Teague comes out. The head bandage. Caught one high. Umpire said play on. He dives in again. And a bounce will be affected.
Now, Doom, you picked it up. We picked it up. Everyone seems to have picked it up except the bloke who's playing on Ian Prendergast. Don't let him be the third man up.
He's just not able to go there with him. Pushes him off once again.
And the same thing happens. This time Dixon, though, positioned himself. Got a bad bounce. Off the ground went Scotland. Jacobs and Norman. Bills for Loney. Now Loney's away from half back. He runs to wing and kicks to half forward. That's good transfer of play up towards Spider, being held out there by Morrell. Good strong play throw in.
But you called it, Gary. That is good coaching by Dennis Pagan. He knows Chance Bateman's on fire. And what he does then is says, all right, he's on fire. He's a small bloke. I will neutralise Everett's effect now by playing Big Ian Prendergast on Chance Bateman around the bounce downs.
Everett stays out of this one. Campbell goes out, thumps it inside the 50. Lap and hand passes out wide. They'll bring it away. Interesting kick from Scotland, a good one. Bounces it out of bounds on the wing as we go down to Tony Jones.
Yeah, and Dennis, it should be said, this match being played before one of the biggest Friday night crowds of the year, Choco Block, and aren't they getting their money's worth?
Yep, just terrific, this one.
Jacobs back down to the Whitnell in the goal square, which allows Smith to miss his run up on half back, so he gets back up the ground.
Now, with this, Joel Smith, he's standing on defensive side of the pack there, and Scott Camporelli comes up to try and deny his run to the ball now.
DeLuca, for one of the few times for Carlton, got it down to Scotland, hooks towards half board. How will it bounce? Awkwardly for all but Johnson. Norman feeds it back outside the 50. Kudafidis lines up, not his best effort. Mm-hmm. Jacobs running back, takes the mark, breaking to our side of the ground. It's Green, not much ahead. Green takes off, kicks to half forward, needs to be precise, clears the target. Thompson backing up is Barker. Green wants it back, runs inside the 50. Thornton closes, put the body in. Green is grabbed by McGrath, jarred out of there. Hodge, slick hand pass, Thompson, deep in the pocket, pushed in the back. Must get a free kick. No, play on's the call.
Just a bit close.
Houlihan comes away, kicks outside the 50. Bateman takes the mark. 60 metres from goal. Hawthorn will put it back in. 56 plays 67.
Kenny Barker's free.
Three players converge on that for the Hawks, and Dixon takes the mark 55 metres out. This will test him.
He was a bit stiff there, Nathan Thompson.
Short one, honours the lead, sets it up. Lekas had it knocked away. Behind is Prendergast, took a while, missed the target, Stevens, ball taken down, Williams, well, sets it very high, it wanders towards the boundary line, and Campbell.
I think it's Dixon, is it?
Campbell.
That was a very good mark by Campbell.
He's got Ladson back long.
He's not a great kick. He'll be really wanting to dish this one off.
Has kicked one behind in his career. No goals.
He's taking plenty of time. Just before halftime last week, a nasty clash with Mark Johnson. Short to Loney. Loney steps to the 50, sets it up. It's close, right on the line. Green lurking behind. Oh. It was a cross. It's that sort of game.
All right, some great passion from both sides here.
Loney just jabbed at the ball there, didn't kick right through it. Touched on the line. It's a 10-point ball game, as you can see. 7 minutes left. Up from behind, Crowe. He's a thumping kick. He gives up the handball to Ball. Now the Hawks go forward again. They're looking for Thompson's being held. His jumper was pulled. No, says the umpire. Thompson again. In the back that time. No, says the umpire. Again, we'll have a bounce.
Ooh, they're letting it go.
They're letting it go. It's good.
Now this is 15 players inside for Carlton inside their defensive 50. This is the one over the line. That's way through. So it's a taxing game, but the one thing that will go for Carlton if they get on a quick break, there is a lot of room to run single opponents around forward of this for Carlton.
Thompson gets the tap, but it's Johnson for the Blues who kicks it into the middle. Cooter's the man. He's got it. Handballs is on, though, decides to kick forward. That was clever football. It'll sit for Houlihan. Crowe has to get this, but he ran past it. Now, gone! Williams with a beautiful tackle, picked up by Norman, whose kick was magnificent. Scotland to the open goal! Kicks his first! Blues by 16!
Well, it was a fast break, and it started back with Brett Johnson once again, who got that all-important clearance in Hawthorn's forward 50. And once it was out, I should ask the question here, how much time did he have? Probably not enough. Williams' tackle was terrific.
That wasn't.
No, he had to hang on, Loney. He had to hang on in the tackle.
Good finisher, Heath Scotland, isn't he?
Yep, excellent.
Carlton have got the last three goals in this one.
He probably didn't have prior opportunity. He only had it like one or two paces there. Great tackle from Williams. Trent really needed to run with the footy and not leave it behind. He made a great decision to leave his man, Crowe. But lovely finish. Scotland's been great tonight.
Campbell, opposed to DeLuca, who knocked it down, follows up into the path of Stevens. Searching hand pass, well done by Lekas. Balls over the football, knocked up in the air by Bowyer, knocked forward by Johnson. Brennan did nicely. Clark out wide, Bateman slipped, found it on the ground. Well done, feeds it to Hodge. He runs away from the congestion. Probing kick inside the 50, storming up to meet it. Morrell gathers it brilliantly, overshoots the target though. Bateman's got it. Runners forward, gives it across to Hodge. That's tracks it around the boundary field. Line. It's coming back, is it?
Yep. To Carlton.
To Carlton.
Spider River, I reckon.
Hang on.
Well, why would you do that? He's been palming so beautifully tonight.
Yeah, that one went straight to the opposition. Literally. And Lance could make them pay. He marks and is told to play on now. No one comes at him, so Lance stands and delivers a big torpedo up forward, up towards Cooter, pushed off the ball. Hawks under pressure. Green does well. Does very well. Ladson.
Yeah, good effort.
Fantastic play by the young Hawks. Rees gets it back to Green. Green, long. Spider O's after that last indiscretion. Was he held? No. Lappin, the former Saints teammates. And Lappin takes it to the boundary line and gets a victory over his old mate.
What he has to do now, Spider, is go back and win the tap. He did exceptionally well there, Lappin, just to keep it away from the big fella. Against the odds, that is a big win for Carlton then.
Teague lets him know as well. DeLuca from behind. It's Pills to Rees. Yeah, the 50 gamer. The little chip inside was a beauty to Thompson. And Thompson marks. Wow.
Some good hands in close. No. Yeah, that's what, when people talk about clean hands. A spider comes to the bench for a spell. Is Rees' hands in tight there? Just watch this.
Nice just, little tap on there, too. Yeah,
just beautiful and then lovely touch. And this Nathan Thompson's looked in pretty good nick from the word go. So the Blues have answered every challenge tonight, and the Hawks still a chance.
Two goals, as you can see, to Nathan Thompson. Blues have kicked the last three. Skycam, Toyota Skycam, putting you on the ground. Thompson comes in and kicks the captain's goal. He's kicked three. The Hawks answer late in the third term.
It was just a little tap away with the ball into his own possession. There it was, called it. Spider Everett had to go back and do something. One possession from there, just follows up, just grabs it into himself. Always looks for a short possession when he gathers. Nick Rees, that's his first thought that goes through his mind. Give off a handball. I'm going to give by a short kick to a teammate. Thompson sensed it, gets on the bike and leads hard.
Let's go down to Tony Jones.
Well, it was Spider himself who indicated to the bench that he was ready for a rest, so he may see out the rest of this quarter and come on reasonably fresh for the last.
Eight men inside, eight backmen for Carlton. Hawthorn manned them up, so they've effectively got eight forwards.
Carlton by 10 points. Back in the middle, Campbell up early. DeLuca knocks it down. Rees hoists it high towards half forward. Dixon lays it off. Ball, a U-turn. Back to Dixon, he's on the wing. Short one, well played out wide. Now an opportunity for Green. Pops it inside the 50. Thompson once more. They're depleted, but they've got wonderful heart tonight. What a transformation. I mean, you think back over the last couple of weeks, their football has been very, very poor.
And that's why eight forwards or seven forwards or nine forwards is important. They won a quick ball out of the middle in the first half. They had numbers back, Carlton. The ball would have been rebounded. Hawthorn match them up, win possession. This is where it ends up.
Thompson going at his fourth there. Steps inside the 50. Oh. He likes it off the boot. And why not? A lot to like right there. He's got four.
And three for the quarter to Nathan Thompson.
When you think about it, since we're halfway through the first quarter now, Gary, every Carlton goal has come from a quick break. And it's been that Pagan's Paddock-style football. You would think that since that point in time, they need some real system rather than get one here or there on the quick breaks.
Nathan Thompson has had some dark moments in recent times. He likes that one. Three goals for the term, two in a row, four for the game. His best goal return since round two. And we've got a four-point ball game. 3 minutes left, third term, Friday night football. Up goes Campbell, gets the tap. Stevens for the Blues, knocks it forward. Wiggins, good strong play. Brennan came out to meet him. It spills for Carl Norman. Norman's 55 out. He kicks to the pocket. Out comes Kuda. Off his boot, he's put it out of bounds on the full. And Loney will take the free kick for Hawthorn in the back pocket. A beautiful kick. He decides to go long and wide, and the Hawks have broken. It spills out to Jacobs. Jacobs looks up. Not much on. He has to hold and wait. Floating handball inside. Oh, it's a hamstring stretcher. Brennan. They're in all sorts of problems now, the Hawks, but Jacobs just holds his composure. Gets it over to ball. On centre wing, the umpire's called play on. I don't know why, he hasn't moved. Now he goes. Breaking tackles, still looking forward. Thompson's his only target. He presents, and he gets dragged down and gets the free kick. Well, it was all for Vola earlier. Now it's Thompson who's stamping himself on this game. Big Nathan Thompson has the ball.
Got Campbell Long, who is an unbelievable one-on-one chance. If he can get it to him, goes wide of him.
Wider still. There's the mark. Off hands. Here he goes. Hodge snaps around the body to put Hawthorn in front. And does! The Hawks have hit the front!
Just one of those super efforts. He saw Brennan Favola in the first half of this game contest the mark, recover quickly and snap. And look, it comes a time in the game where you just got to stand your ground. It's not ideal, but you've got to give the strongest possible contest. At worst, control the ball to the front. Look, Hodge has no right here. Just controls it to the front, gives himself another opportunity. And on the non-preferred foot, that is a finish.
Robbie Campbell, after they... I mean, Spider came out in this third quarter and Carlton turned it around after he was dominant. And now Robbie Campbell's having a bit of a say in the midfield here. Carlton needs some centre-bounce takeaways here. They need to put a goal on the board desperately.
Approaching three-quarter time, Prendergast went up. Hand pass forward by Camporelli. Whitnell off his step inside the 50. Taken by Koutafidis, tried to lay it off, missed the target. Reese slips it away to Hodge, swings it out wide. Green's got it now, he's on the wing. Movement from Barker, movement from Green. Dashes inboard, probing kick inside the 50. Thompson again, almost the inspired mark. Couldn't complete it. Norman heads for the boundary line and gets it out. Well, football is a remarkable game. Suddenly the inspiration, the adrenaline is pumping through the Hawks. In the last 2 weeks, they've played like strangers on a prison bus, but not tonight. A minute 20 from three-quarter time, Hawthorn by two.
Good hit. Beautiful stuff. In he goes, Camporelli. No need to be silly here, the Hawks. Smith doing.
64% of the footy they've had this last 10 minutes, Hawthorn. And importantly, Stephen Green starting to get a bit of the footy. Pushing up the ground, Lappin's letting him go, and wisely, Hawthorn are using Green.
Hodge will kick a goal here. Hawks they get a takeaway here, the Hawks.
Derm and Gary have both been saying how Carlton have played a brand of football which would leave tired legs. Well,
taxing.
Three goals in 3 minutes to the Hawks from the 23-minute mark to just under the 27-minute mark in that, call it, four-minute period. We're down to... And nearly 30 seconds in this quarter.
And importantly, Spider set out the last five. You'll get the three-quarter time break, come back on with a pretty good petrol tank.
One last shot for the Hawks. Up to Thompson again. Off the hands of the pack. Williams goes to ground. Now he gets it out. Hodges in there. Ball up. 15 seconds and counting from now. Umpire hasn't blown time off, so it'll tick down. Oh, what a final quarter we're in for here. 6-3 in the third term to the Hawks. It came in threes, the first three from 1 minute to 5 minute to the Hawks, then the next three to the Blues, and then the next three to the Hawks, and they lead at the final break by 2 points. Barbara and Ian Dicker smiling and clapping at last. You feel for the president, but I feel for the president's wife the last couple of weeks. That is a tough gig, let me tell you.
Mrs. Maguire gets the odd belt occasionally.
Oh, boy, do they carry the pain. Carlton, 11-7-73. Hawthorn, 12-3-75. Friday Night Football at its best.
But we're in for a cracker.
We are indeed. Ian Collins and wife Mary watching on with Dr. Jeffrey Edelston in the foreground as we start the final turn.
Everett, as he's done for most of the night, knocked it down. Johnson smothered off the boot. Spills out. Ladson slides in. Whistle, ball up.
Digby Morrell has now gone to Thompson.
There's the doc, Dr. Jeffrey Edelston, sitting next to Ian Dicker there.
His turn.
Yeah. Ian and Mary Collins. Of course, the president and president's wife of Carlton.
Well, Everett initially, and then Ladson out wide. Fickle bounce over the head of White. Brennan kicks inside the 50. Teague will need to come, and he does. Big fist on that one. Back to midfield. Everett again, looking for options. Spots a man out wide. Uses the ball to Tallis. And Talis down towards half forward, about 75 metres from goal.
Thompson will want to come out this side of the ground. The ball's drawn by Barker.
The space in front of Barker. Thornton did well, took the arms, got away with it. Morrell, or is it Whitnell? It's Whitnell who kicks it on the bounce to Prendergast. Left half back, comes back towards the middle. Dangerous. Camporelli behind. Finds it on the ground. Yes, he does. Stevens arches the back. Slips it wider still. McGrath kicks to half forward. Plenty of Hawks down there. Hodge has been good, but not that time. Well, he made amends. Slaps it out. Charging in Stevens once more. Wrestled down by Talis. And a bounce across half forward. Let's go down to the dock.
Well, Dennis Carlton throwing everything this quarter. They've got their most inexperienced on the bench. They've got their most senior 18 out there. The only problem with Hawthorn, Jonathan Hay looks very uncomfortable. May not get back out there for the Hawks.
Hodge cramped on the edge of this bounce now.
Big Carl Norman goes in, grabs it, kicks inside 50 over the head of Favola. Almost made it to the goal square. Almost to Lance Whitnor. Hodge slaps it on the boot and clears it out to the wing position. Teague and Dixon. Teague did it well, kept his feet. Latson under pressure. Stevens, Teague, Stevens. The recruits of Carlton working well. It spills out to McGrath, another one, who finds a player out wide, and the mark's been taken by Houlihan. With the silky skills, he looks up. Favola doubles back. It kicks inside. But Favola needed over the head, and Crode was there and took the mark.
I think it was intended for Heath Scotland. He ran through, but it was just misdirected by about 7 or 8 metres.
Bateman on defensive 50, despite Everett on the centre wing position. Good pressure from behind by Prendergast. Over the line, out of bounds, throw in.
Yeah, Prendergast is going to run with Spider Everett for this whole last quarter. Wherever he goes, he's a good athlete, Prendergast. Going to give a big contest.
47,302 in tonight for this big night at the Telstra Dome, Friday Night Football.
Lappin has dragged Stevie Green away from his forward line and taken him up into his own forward line in change.
Everett backhands it down. Joel Smith taken down. McGrath is number 20. We'll have a ball up. Just forward of right centre wing.
Better off in this desperate last quarter to, you know, hold on to the footy if you're in any doubt and force another ball up rather than let the footy spill out.
Hawks by 2 points. Everett missed it that time. Bell at his feet. Goes again. This has been a remarkable performance. Prendergast. Was he taken high? No.
Yep, high. I think he caught it.
Oh,
yep,
okay.
High. Further afield caught it.
So he gets a free kick. Willing worker, but fighting out of his division at the moment. Goes down towards half forward. Johnson is there. In fact, it's Kurtafidis who gave the contest, lurking behind Waite. Could have been taken high. Camporelli feeds it back. Stevens goes to Johnson, who peeled off the pack.
Now, Wiggins should be the target here if he gets to him quickly.
Johnson sets it up towards full forward. Wiggins runs back towards the contest. Not required. Kurtafidis, 10 metres out, marks on his chest. The unlikely hero in many respects. His first run tonight. For all of 3 minutes.
he's looked like a player that hasn't played much footy, Cooter, but you know he'll keep coming. He's had 8 possessions, actually, which is not too bad for the amount of time he's been on, but, gee, important kick here.
Huge kick. In he comes and kicks truly. Carlton back in front.
Have to put a score on the board here, the Blues. In the first 3 quarters, we've seen them just get overrun in about the 17-18 minute mark of each quarter. They have to get a bit of a buffer up here and take the drive, the sting out of Hawthorn, and the will to succeed by that point in the game.
So King Kuta is back in business. His first goal in 2004. And the Blues hit the front again. Stevens out of the centre. Nice kick up to Lance, who crashes the pack. 2 Hawks stay down. Lance grabs the footy. He kicks at the corner. He's going to give a free kick. It's coming back.
It's going back to Clark. I reckon it's against Scotland.
Did not spot it, Gaz.
Yes, I think they saw Lance Whitnell coming, so he just held Clark out of the contest.
Ooh. We'll have a look at that. We'll get the replay in the marking contest. Clark wobbles it out. That was a huge free kick because Kuta was away for his second in a minute. They would have lifted the roof here. Loney kicks forward. Teague with courage. Norman. Take two, Norman. Cop one high. No, oh, says the umpire. Ball, says the umpire.
He was sticky.
Let's have a look at it here. Camporelli is the man who has given away the free kick.
Didn't look much in it. Tough. Didn't look much in
That's
it.
That's a
all.
Tough one. Dixon. The blokes go for the ball.
Dixon wants Thompson here.
Dixon short to the pocket. Over the head of Williams, over the line and out of bounds. I'd like to have another look at that if we can. Spool it back, boys.
And low percentage play again from Dixon. I mean, you got Thompson on fire. Give him a chance at the top of the square.
Oh, it's a marginal hold, but
can't see. You can't see from that angle.
Okay, away we go.
After the boundary throw in, the bodies, as you'd expect, going willingly. Hodge, now we've got a whistle, and this time the umpire's going to ball it up, and Carl Norman can't believe it. He's thinking about what happened to him moments ago, and in fact, what happened to him in the dying moments of last week against Adelaide in the pocket. He didn't learn his lesson, but he thinks he knows the rule. He knocked it down. Bateman's got it. Claimed immediately. Hoddle. Oh. Was he taken high? The kick floats towards the kickoff line. Spilt down there by Williams. He recovers well. Deep in the pocket. Pulls it back across his body. Right on the line. Houlihan didn't complete the mark. Keeping it alive was Clark. It's 10 metres out. Ball charges in. He's claimed by Norman. Norman will be ropeable. It's still a live football down there. And eventually a free kick is going to the Blues.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, that's a pressure valve situation.
How good was it? Carlton had 12 players within 10 metres of their goal square then. How much pressure is attached to that?
That McGrath. Was on one side and the cheer squad on the other.
Out of defence, McGrath's kick high, fell in front, charging in was Fisher, in the opposite direction, down goes Clark. Whistle, ball up on the wing.
Now you see Brendan Favola, this is the Hodge from Norman.
Wow.
Not much.
You need another look at that. He might have gone all the way around his melon.
I think it's a free kick.
It's a free, yeah.
He's cramping on after every attempt at the ball, Luke Hodge.
He is. He has run himself into the ground tonight. Not a huge preparation as Favola put Smith in the sandwich.
Yeah, that's Brendan Favola on centre wing. From a Hawthorn point of view, that's where you want him. He should be heading back to the goal square right now, running back really hard.
That's a good bump, that one. That's a rib tickler, and Smith is still in all sorts of trouble there.
Now what he needs to do is stand right where the umpire's going to bounce it so he can get a bit of air.
He needs to get off. Yeah. He's going to be one man down right here.
He has to get right off now. Dr. Peter Larkins will get an update in a moment. That is bang. I'll make the diagnosis there. Sore ribs. Crunch. Pete, you've got anything for us?
Oh, he's just coming up towards me at the moment, Ed. He's taking some deep breaths. He looks pretty uncomfortable. They're just talking to him in the physio, so we'll see how they go when they examine him here.
Okay, Rees came on. Wiggins, a high up and under. Up towards Favola again. Just edged underneath it nicely there by Crow. Took a strong mark. That's good football.
And he's got Spider straight down the line. That's his safety against Prendergast, if he can get a one-on-one. Now Carl Norman comes across. Brendan's got to make a move here.
Favola has six for the night.
Now that's bottling him up. He should get it back here. And now Brennan is on, if he can get it there.
Crow, does he trust himself with a short pass though? Decides to go long. Breeze, a one-on-one. Whitnall does it well. Gets to the ball, couldn't quite hold it, then couldn't pick it up. But locks it up nicely, Big Lance. He has really put in tonight, no doubt about it, in his 150th game. And Joel Smith sucks in the air. Look at that possession time in the match. 42%, 43%, 15 in dispute.
Don't get much closer than that. And on the scoreboard, 4 points in favour of Carlton.
Spider knocks it out again. Norman taken down by Tallis. Charging through Johnson, got it to Teague, floats one towards half forward. Lappin edged under the football, loose at the back. Leading in the race is Waite. Waite paddles it inside his forward 50, controls it well, steps around Green, 50 metres out, goes looking for Favola. Test of strength. Crowe takes the mark and it stands.
Yeah, he's won some important ball in the last few minutes, Trent Crowe.
Drives it towards the outer side, looking for Tallis. It was a very good kick. Somehow got it in between two Blues. Tallis hugs the boundary line. Did it bounce? I thought it did. So did the umpire. And then it went across the line. Bateman can't believe it.
Yeah, he knows he was trying to stooge the umpy then. Little wry smile. Jessica, they've got to put another couple on the board here, Carlton. They've died away in the last 10 minutes of each of the first three quarters.
Good call by the boundary umpire. Well done. McGrath, Johnson, quick hands, Scotland, Cooter, tried to flick it out. He heard the call from Camporelli. Loney kept his feet all through all that, and he's got the ball. Now he handballs inside. The Hawks building through Lekas. Concede some ground to open it up. Clark's handball didn't hit the target, but Green, who was great in that third quarter, picks it up and kicks and finds a man. It's Johnny Barker. He has got Williams on. His opponent fell over. Williams has got it!
Yes, he did, Glennie Bowyer. He just slipped at the all-important time when Williams made his lead, and that was enough. Had he been side by side, you'd suspect he would have got a fist because the kick wasn't outstanding. But Johnny Barker presenting up.
Watch as he falls
there
over
goes.
There.
Just a stumble there. He did have to stop a bit, Williams, and he couldn't quite get there.
So Williams has kicked one goal tonight. Will we see the shotgun come out if he puts the Hawks in front? The kick is on its way. Bang, he says. Shoots the ball right through the middle. Hawks back in front.
Well, it's a good finish. And there's a little bit of that trend continuing here. The Blues started this quarter really well. In the last 5 minutes, the Hawks have started to win some footy. The young blokes, Green and Clark, worked it out pretty well in the middle of the ground. It was hard in the mouth stuff early. But they are continuing to run and run pretty hard. Joel Smith comes back onto the side, onto the ground rather. But that's a nice finish.
Hawthorn by 2 points then. Time in front tonight, Carlton 86 minutes, Hawthorn 12 minutes. Mark McLean, played by Johnny Crawford in the Rifleman. There you go.
There you go.
He went with the left hand too.
Look out, Chuck Connors. 13-3, 12-7, a thriller at the dome. Everett tries to flick it down behind, brilliantly done. Breeze scrambles it forward. Chopped off though and kicked across the ground by McGrath. Pitches on its point, arriving quickly Scotland to Camporelli. Camporelli looks towards the middle. Awkward half volley for Whitnell, went down and found it. Tries to lay it off. Now an opportunity for Prendergast. It's a tired kick. In front, the mark is held down there by Osborne. Just on the ground, plays on. Swings it out wide, the big man. How did he get there? Everett, out of defence, a little chip. Short of the desired target, Green. Boundary throw in on the other side. Bateman goes in. That appeared to be a throw. Had to be a throw, didn't it? It's out of bounds. It'll be thrown in. Watch it again.
More throw than handball.
Plenty of guide with the guiding hand, wasn't there?
Yeah. That's one way of saying it.
Yeah, plenty of guide. A lot of guide with it.
Throw in.
Oh, what a great
big
shot.
9.25 minutes we've got on Friday Night Football. 2 points of difference. Hawthorn in front. Spider got the tap, but it's Johnson who runs onto the ball. Dragged down by Smith back on the ground, but Favola's got it. He is inside 50, which means he is well within range. Big Brendan hasn't kicked a goal this term. He's kicked at least one in every other. Three in the first, two in the second, and one in the third. Look at this.
Gee, it was well done by Brett Johnson there. Yeah. Nick Rees just got too close in to Peter Everett then for the tap out.
I wonder whether now Spider should just be belting this thing forward from a Hawthorn point of view, because that went Carlton's side. Johnson has been very good early, ran onto it. Now look who's got it. This man has been on fire.
This for the third change of lead in the final term, which has been going 14 and a half minutes. This for Brennan Favola's seventh goal. He kicked seven last week. He's 80% from outside 50.
Coming back.
He bends it left to right. Too much. Play on. Touch on the line. It's still in play. Ugh. Great play by Lappin. Did he get one in the back or too high? Nothing, says the umpire. A rush behind. It's a point the difference at the dome.
I'll tell you what Brendan Favola did do very well was just open it up beautifully. He came inside about five metres, I reckon.
Games decided by under 10 points this season. Carlton have had 2 wins and a loss. Hawthorn 1 win and 2 losses.
They're going to get choked here, the Hawks. There's no long targets, only one. Crowed.
Joel Smith to himself, runs away out of the back pocket. Sends play very wide. It pitches just inside the boundary line and goes out. Interesting, Dennis Pagan, coaching in his 12th season, has never coached a draw.
Hawks have had 2 1-point losses this season so far. 1 point up at the moment.
Boundary throw in, a mismatch as you can see. Crowe did well as well. Got rid of Prendergast. It came to Crowe from Everett. Stolen away, though, by Wiggins. Very high ball inside the 50. The bowler is up. Punched away by Jacobs. Loney, Green. Clever football. Osborne to no one in particular. Now a chance for Whitnell across the body. How will it bounce? Premature celebration, but I think it's good. The bowler was waving his arms. Now the goal umpire is.
Yeah, it's got a good football brain, a smart footy brain, knows where they are. The Hawks worked it out in the middle of the ground earlier with pretty good hands. On that occasion, Carlton just strangled them and closed them down, and the turnover eventually came. This hand was okay. The Osborne one under some sort of pressure wasn't. He doesn't have much time to work in, Lance, on that occasion. He just knows where they are. And Brendan did go off early.
Huge atmosphere here at the Telstra Dome. Lance Whitnell in his 150th. He kicked the first of the game. Now he's kicked the last of the game so far. Carlton back in front. Fourth change of lead in the final term. Just over 7 minutes left. Here come the Hawks now as it comes out through Clark. He kicks it up towards Barker. Punched away from behind by Thornton. Here's Loney close to the boundary line. The ball stays in and stays in and stays in. Umpire bounces now, close to the boundary line. Coming up to 7 minutes left in this game. Plenty of time. Russell Green and his wife, Roxy, watching on. Their son, Stevens, played a mighty second half for the Hawks. Barker grabs it, only needed to be grabbed to be in trouble. He got it out to Smith, dragged off the ball, then didn't get boot the ball. That's a free kick to Carlton. It'll be 50 here. He's got to be careful. Yep, there it is. Yep, Smith's been a little bit over-enthusiastic a couple of times tonight, and it has finally gone against him. And the Blues now take the ball from half-back to pretty much half-forward.
So this should land in the goal square. They'll look for Brendan Favola. He's their safest kick. All the Carlton players are going to stay up around the 50. Hawthorn might try and peel back on them and just block up this room for the lead. They've got to go to Favola.
Wiggins to Favola from behind. Spider got into the hole, couldn't hold it. The Cooter gets it out. Here's a chance now for Diggers. Digby Morrell kicks to the square. Lance is back there. Bounced off Lance's chest through for a rush behind. Ooh, it's a goal, the difference, a kick in it. 6.5 minutes. Dennis Pagan might get his first draw. Dennis Cometti.
Danny Jacobs to bring it in. Wonderful heart tonight from the Hawks. Reese, interesting. They've got a problem now. Reese in trouble. Feeds it back to the square. Jacobs with some time.
Set play.
Measured the kick beautifully. Taken by Crow. Over the top ball, perhaps. Goes towards half forward. Hodges got it now, 75 metres out. Looks down towards full forward, sets it up. Storming up is Williams. Awkward half volley. Controlled it pretty well. Found it on the deck. Right on the 50. Goes around the perimeter. Hodges got it. It's a long kick.
He's about 55
metres out. He goes long towards full forward. In front, Morrell down there. Loose ball. Johnson leads in the race back and pushes it across the line.
Nathan Thompson was red hot in the third quarter. Just hasn't been able to draw the footy in the last quarter. They just haven't been able to get to him for that contest.
Margin, 5 points. Blues on top.
Stevens brings the ball in to McGrath. 6 rush behinds the Carlton. Just the one to Hawthorn, that one.
Pete Scotland's got 3.
Shows you how close they've had it to the goals, the Blues. Spider flies from the front, Lappin waited at the back and got it. Out he goes to Houlihan, decides to take him on a run, gets a nice shepherd, 2 bounces, knows Barker can't chase him down. Now on the left boot, the kick inside 50, Blues have got the numbers, off the hands of the pack, Scotland, look at him go, he loves a goal, he's Scotland, he had it a while though. Bounces the umpire, 45 metres out, directly in front of the Carlton goal.
Brennan's sprinting off the ground as good as he can, he's cramped up a few times, Raiden, Tullis. Set to come back on.
There's the attendance, a great attendance too. 47,302. They've got a thriller as Whitnell picks it out of the pack, kicks to the goal line, and Crowe knocks it through for a rush behind. Now the seventh of the night. It's a goal, the difference again.
They've struggled with their kick-ins, Hawthorn.
Yeah, there's a few cramping out there. Spiders just about gone.
He needs a break right now.
He needs a big spell.
And then back for about the last 2.5 minutes. It's funny enough, they need to bring it down to that sort of basis. He's got to play on here, Loney.
Smith to Loney, swings it out wide. Jacobs up on the wing this time. A runner alongside. Well done by Johnson. He worked the mark. Well done by Osborne. Got it back to Jacobs. Ball just forward of the wing. Looks inside the 50. Now decides to hand pass. How will it bounce? Lodi's got it. 55 metres out. Goes long.
Set play.
It's a goal. Scores a level.
Well, Derm, if there's one bloke in your side that you'd want to have with the ball in that situation,
60 out,
is Nathan Loney.
Yeah, maybe Lukey Hodge, but he's cramped up and he's gone out of the game this quarter. They've kept him out on the ground for his tenacity, but he wasn't sure whether he was going to go for it here, Loney. That is a big pump from outside too. They almost got that goal and the length of the ground to get it there by accident, Hawthorn.
Scores a level at the Telstra Dome. 86 points apiece. Carlton have had 23 scoring shots to 18. There's never been a draw between these two teams in 149 contests. Here we go. Out of the centre. Rees for Hawthorn. And it comes. Hodge couldn't quite hold it. Houlihan. It's spilled out of his hands to lap it around the body. Good play by the young player there in Simpson. He got it down. Thornton under pressure, dropped the ball. Got one high. Up by it, too high.
And it was.
Yep. Dropped the ball.
It's going to react quick. They're going to react quick here.
Two chances gone begging to Hawthorn. Now Thornton kicks to half forward. Beautiful Mark Fisher. At half forward flank, Fisher has the ball, scores level. Inside 4 minutes to go, Fisher's kick. It'll come off, the ball spills. Prendergast to the open goal, has put it through! Carlton hit the front! Carlton are a goal up!
That's the thing, if you go quick when there are tired players and you win possession, if you're prepared to go quick, there's every chance you'll find someone. It's one of those situations where you almost can play on blind because there'll be someone there. Now, Spider had just let Prendergast sneak out the back there. He was there for a long time. Eventually, it got to him. Spider too tired, really, to bend over. He's worked enormously hard, and that's a great finish.
Prendergast has been very good in this final term. Spider, a tired man. Couldn't stretch far enough.
He has been enormous, but I mean, that is terrific from young Prendergast. He's a great athlete. We're told he's a terrific runner.
A good endurance athlete. He just ran forward on him there, and he is continuing to run. He might not win the hit-outs, but he'll run off Spider.
He's up against it here. Not aided by a very good bounce. Everett hooked it down behind. We'll have another bounce. When I say not aided by a very good bounce, you know what I mean. It was a straight bounce, and every time it's straight, Everett is favoured by that. Now, of course, Prendergast can get some body on the big fellow. Complete with a mural on his left shoulder. Up he goes, tries to knock it down, spills behind, and Waite wanted it most. Dived in under Clark.
He looked like he was going that long one, then Spider, just to get that ball moving, which wouldn't be a bad option. Big fist in it, move it forward.
94 plays 88. Inside the centre square, Prendergast and Everett over the top, thumped forward by Simpson, the youngster. Another youngster, Fisher, claimed and put down by Osborne. Green grabs it, hurried kick beyond the wing. McGrath leads back in the race, going back towards his own half-back line. Taken down by Loney, taken out by Houlihan. Just over 2.5 minutes to go.
Good result for the Blues. McGrath, smart.
The Hawthorn team, hands in face, faces in hands, hands in mouth, you name it, edge of the seat stuff. 2.5 minutes left, they had a couple of little half chances.
Everett to full forward.
Hodge just spilled a mark, little free kick against Bateman.
The Blues have been terrific.
They have fought and fought the Blues. 3-2 this term, Gary.
Answered every little challenge that's come their way, the Blues. They've always been able to find a goal when they've needed it.
Have kept fighting and fighting. 2.5 minutes, there's plenty of time left for a couple of scores in this game. We're at half forward for Hawthorn. Thompson goes up, couldn't quite get his hand on the ball, but he gets it now. The big skipper runs from 65, kicks it out in front of Williams. In the back, wasn't no, couldn't hold the mark. Spider comes in to lend assistance. Lappin flicks it out. This is a crucial play. Houlihan took them on, then dropped the ball. Lappin went to ground, ball up 40 metres out from the Hawthorn goal.
What a tackle by Hodge. you'd assume that 9 out of 10 people couldn't stick that tackle, but the boy made it stick, and that's where the ball remains.
That was a passage of footy then. That was a passage of footy.
Desperation for the men in the stands. They know they can't do anything but hope. Spider taps it to the back. Good play by Ladson, knocks it forward. Hodges in there, inside 2 minutes. Another ball up. We're 25 metres out from the Hawthorn goal. Peter Schwab can barely watch it.
Can Spider manufacture something here?
Here we go. Inside a minute and three quarters. Over the top, McGrath gave it a big thump. It'll sit for Loney, will it? No. Morrell goes in. Desperation. In fact, a little bit too desperate there. The Hawthorn players would have been better off just sitting off him. But a ball up, and the umpire's now very quick with the time off. A minute 31 left on the clock.
Yeah, they, Carlton, want to get this, or at least not let Spire direct this down to one of their teammates. They want to clear this area.
Ian Dicker, Steve Layton, the CEO. Poor boy, what a quarter of football they've had to go through. They trail by a goal. Carlton have been magnificent as Digby Morrell clears.
Goldsmith over the football. Beats a would-be tackler. Comes back to Crowe. Normally a monster kick. This is very high. Morrell's in front, and that could be for the game. A minute to go, Morrell spots Prendergast and or Favola. Kicks beyond Prendergast, and Favola's got it now inside the last minute.
In front of the Carlton bench, you'd reckon they'd be telling him that it's inside a minute. Strong down the line, Whitnell's down the line, Koutafidis is down the line.
Favola going for distance, not his best work. It tumbles to the 50, and Camporelli.
That could be for the game.
Good players, good players. I mean, everyone should be proud of themselves tonight, but good players can do this sort of stuff against quality opposition. Stand your ground, protect the area where the ball's going to drop.
Now the Carlton runner's out there and just tells him to quieten it down. Peter Schwab, in that coach's box there, they have a second clock that ticks right down to the sign. He knows exactly where it's at.
Camporelli from 55. Long. Has it got the carry? Not quite. Fisher. 5 metres out. He will kick after the siren. And this place erupts. And so does Peter Schwab. The Blues celebrate. Spider Everett almost too tired to raise a handshake. Fisher kicks a goal. And those young men, those young Hawks looking on, now understand exactly what flows from their actions last Saturday. They were helpless, and the Blues have won tonight in a thriller. At various times in the 80s, these two sides provided the who's who of the competition. Well, tonight, starting out, it was more the who's he, but what a game they provided.
What a game indeed, Dennis. And let's not take anything away from this side. The Carlton Football Club have been able to win their second consecutive game for the first time since the elimination final of 2001. This proud club, the Carlton Football Club, came to play tonight. They knew that Hawthorn would throw everything at them, and they've been successful. And Tony Jones is with one of their best.
Oh, boy, wasn't he great tonight. Well, Brendan, 13 goals in 2 weeks, mate. 6 tonight, 7 last week. Have you ever played in a game like this before?
We're in patches. I think we kicked the first couple, they kicked them, and then they kicked the... And we kicked a couple, they kicked a couple. We just went like that all night. And we knew we had it in us. We did it last week in the last quarter. And Campo said to us at three-quarter time, we did it last week, we got it in us. Just locked down like the first quarter and come over the win. We haven't bloody won two in a row for about 4 years, so it feels good.
It certainly does, and there are a few incentives, of course. The big fella, his 150th game in Whitnall.
And Jono played his 50th as well. And Big Red was awesome today. He's back to his best, and hopefully he can continue on.
And did Dennis pump that message home this week, that Hawthorn, the week that they've had, you know, that you just...
We didn't really worry about that. We know they're a good team, and they're a proud club. They're passionate, and we just had to come out and play our footy. And we played it. We had a bit of a lapse in the second quarter, but we got a good rev up by Cocker, and we come out with a win.
And what about wins like this? Can you draw on this for, like, weeks to come?
Oh, certainly, especially we've got next Saturday night against the Tigers here, and then we go to the break, and hopefully if we get up and win that one, we're in the eight, which will be good.
All right, bring it on. Well done.
Brendan Favola with Tony Jones, and great to see a standing ovation from the Hawthorn cheer squad for their team tonight. Disappointed, they lost by 2 goals in the end, a kick from Fisher on the siren.
But full marks to Carlton. They kicked 4-2 in that final term, including the last two that counted. The scores were level till the 22-minute mark of the final term, and Carlton kicked the last two. Bit of disappointment for the Hawthorn fans, but the sort of showing that they've been desperate for. And a big effort for these two men, Anthony Koutafidis and Digby Morrell, because they're carrying Lance Whitnall off the ground. And what a game it has been for Lance. They lift the Blues, there's no doubt, in milestone games, and they lifted tonight for Lance Whitnall, who kicked 2 himself, the first of the game, to spark this Carlton revival. There'll be a presentation in a moment for the David Parkin Medal for the best player on the ground. Tony Jones will have all that, probably from within the rooms. We'll stick with this as we go in. What an emotional night, not only for the Hawthorn Football Club. Let's not forget, it has been 3 years for the famous dark old Navy Blues to sing the song, the old Lily of Laguna, 2 weeks on the trot. They'll enjoy this. A huge crowd in tonight, 47,302. And a massive TV audience on Friday Night Football as the Carlton Football Club, who have the worst running record at this ground. It has been a horror few years for them. And Dennis Pagan goes in to join his troops. Look at that, Brendan Favola and Dennis Pagan. That is an emotional embrace there. 2 weeks ago, Dennis taught Brendan a lesson, played him at full back. Since then, the lesson has been learnt. He's kicked 13 goals and back-to-back wins. Here we go, the Blues song. Famous old Dark Blues have racked up a great win tonight by 12 points against Hawthorn. Lance Whitnall, Dennis Pagan in there, McGrath was excellent, and Kuda. Well, you just can't keep him out of the game. In his second game back, he's captained the Blues twice this year to two big wins against the old enemy, the Magpies, and tonight against the Hawks. Kuda kicked the goal to put Carlton in front in the final term. It had everything tonight. What a wonderful game of football we saw on Friday Night Football. Final term, Hawthorn kicked 2, Carlton kicked the 4, and it was that 2 that made the difference. It was 2 points of difference at three-quarter time, but at full time, Carlton have defeated Hawthorn 15-10-100, and they have defeated Hawthorn 12-3-75. We'll be back with a presentation of the David Parkin Medal, a full wrap-up from the rooms right after this. This is Friday Night Football. This is AFL on Nine.
I'm Brendan Favola. This is my Friday Night.